So Greymane is out. Came out, he's been in the game files for a while. Quite a few people got to see him before he was ready. He even got to press the tri-mode button back before he was officially released. But I got to play him on the BlizzCon floor. It was a horrible representation of what Greymane is possible of. On the BlizzCon floor, there is no MMR. There are a lot of people who came for other games, World of Warcraft, Hearthstone, StarCraft, who see Heroes of the Storm on the floor and go, oh man, I haven't tried that at home. Maybe I'll give it a shot with these cool new characters. Got in, and as an experienced MOBA player, I destroyed them. And I walked out of that pit feeling pretty bad, actually. Greymane, some amazing, amazing damage on the guy. He blew up everybody, and when you understand body language, like I talk a lot about on this show, you can identify very quickly which of your enemies is not a good player. And if you are an assassin of the level of a Thrall, Kerrigan, Butcher, or Greymane in this case, that can close the distance and get the kill pretty easily, you can destroy characters who don't understand how to play a game like this. So it marred my experience a little bit. I had a lot of fun doing it, but immediately felt awful. So now Greymane is out. We can actually be, you know, productive. We can see what he's up to. If this is your first day joining me for a new hero, things go a little bit differently. We start out going into the try mode. We're going to try out the hero, see if we can work through a build that we want to settle on before we take him into AI. Well, verse AI, when we win one of those games, depending, we'll take him into quick match after that. And of course, there'll be plenty of time for us to hang out with the chat and all that in between quick match games, because those load times will of course be very, very long. But before we get into that, when we talked about Lunara, we talked about a little bit of the history of the character, and I was impressed with Lunara, what they did to the Dryad class to make it its own. Lunara hasn't really worked out. A lot of people are pretty upset about Wisp still. She's a little undertuned for a lot of people's taste. I think she's in a great place if we didn't have our current burst meta. If we were still talking Nazebos back in the day, I mean, that was just poison damage into Ravaging Spirit. I don't think Lunara brings too much different from that to the table. It's just our current meta isn't a good place for a hero like Lunara to come out. So quite a few people are scared about Greymane for the same reasons. A squishy melee hero added into the game at this point is just going to get blown up, but he should be embraced the same way that we have our Kerrigans, Butchers, Illidans embraced, with Divine Palms and Divine Shields to keep him going. I have been playing werewolves for a long time. This is Dota. This is Defense of the Ancients in Warcraft 3. And if you can see this little guy dancing right here, the model for the original Lycanthrope character was Archimon on foot. He was one of the original jungle characters. Jungling is something that doesn't really happen in Heroes of the Storm as much because the jungles are kind of small. Jungles refer to mercenary camps. And in games like Dota and League of Legends, when you take a mercenary camp, they just die and give you gold. So what you do is, it's an additional part for soak. And remember, in those sort of MOBAs, that every single person has their own XP. So if someone is in one lane by themselves, they are gaining more XP just for themselves, and they will be a higher level character than their opponents in the lane who have two characters there, because that XP is being split in two. It's not shared like in Heroes of the Storm. So bringing a jungler to the team like Lycanthrope is an extremely powerful tool to allow other heroes to solo lane, get maximum XP, and you're in the jungle, able to kill all those bandits and, you know, owl bears and whatnot in there, getting XP for yourself, getting money for yourself, for your items, and then you come exploding out of the woods and attacking people when you hit level 6. The reason he was able to do this was because he had summoned wolves. He could summon these two little wolves in front of him, and in fact, the character went on to be part of Dota 2, the Valve-made Dota. This is Lycan here, one of my original main characters. Sadly, his expectations changed a lot over the years from sort of this heavy ganker carry character into more of a jungler, which I was okay at. And nowadays, he has a very unique style that really only very experienced Lycans are going to play. And those who don't play him regularly enough will disappoint their teammates by not executing the perfect Lycan. So he's kind of worked himself into a tough corner there. One of the things I'm really impressed about by Greymane is the fact that they didn't do shapeshift. And I think when we're all making up our own characters in our heads, one of the easiest abilities to say is metamorphosis. Illidan will turn into a big demon. Muradin will turn into his avatar form. And werewolves, naturally, their top ability should be to turn into a werewolf. And with Greymane, I'm very excited to see how this works out. I hope their investment, it's certainly a time investment on Blizzard, say a creativity investment in making this character a little more dynamic and flow between the wolf and the range character, should be pretty awesome. And the fact that he's ranged makes him a rather unique werewolf character among various MOBAs. I know League of Legends has its own. I looked up the guy briefly, but I don't have much to say on the character as I never played much League of Legends. So let's dive into this. We're of course going to start out with that try mode here for Greymane and the Ringmaster. Nope, it's a bit silly for me. And he's a lion form, you know, were-lion. Yeah, he does have some great animations. That was fast. Let's dive into it. Let's go ahead and we'll toggle off those minions for now. And we're set to level 1, so we're all set here. Let's see what we got at level 1. Actually, no. Let's see our basic abilities first. Oh my goodness, that got... Whoa. That is a complicated-looking little tooltip. We got Gilneas Cocktail. Hurl a flask, dealing damage to the first enemy it hits, and exploding for 215 damage to the enemies in a cone behind them. So, my first question is, does it explode behind them if it doesn't hit a character? I don't know. That didn't tell me anything. Let's go ahead and toggle cooldowns. Okay, yes. Alright, so if it doesn't hit a character at all, Gilneas Cocktail just breaks sadly across the ground. Oh my. And there is no sort of favors to those arrows. If it does not connect, there's very little they're going to do for you. Cool, looks like we're going to be dealing with double abilities, of course, so let's make our way through the human ones first. Inner Beast. Gain 50% attack speed for 3 seconds. Basic attacks refresh the duration. Oh, okay, so we pop it. We got 3 seconds of bonus attack speed. It goes away. We pop it. 3 seconds of bonus attack speed. There's the time. Oh, nice. That's a cute little timer. Nice little old-timey watch for the guy. All right, so as long as you're... Ooh. Oh, that's kind of cool. It has combo points. Not that I don't think I can spend them anywhere, but that's still pretty cool. Excellent. 25-hit combo. I'm amazing. Dark Flight. Cooldown 6 seconds. Shapeshift into a worgen and leap at the enemy, causing damage. Alright, well let's go ahead and get our werewolf on. Pretty decent range. Looks about the range of a Ravage on Kerrigan. And basically does the same thing. But now our abilities are changed. We are a werewolf. Whoa. Look at that thing. Oh, okay. They made it all swipey. It kind of looks like those rockin' chops they sell on TV. For your salads. Swipe the area in front of you, dealing damage. Cool. Oh. Alright, important to note, you take a step forward. Okay, so if a line shot is coming at me, probably still wouldn't use it to dodge. I could probably get there in just as quick clicking. But, you know, interesting application. 3 second cooldown. 30 mana. Wonder if the guy will have any mana issues. Inner Beast. Same thing. Glad he keeps the watch. Okay, and abilities, of course, do not count as basic attacks. So if I use too many abilities, I could interrupt this. Do I keep it when I disengage, roll away, and turn into human? Does my inner beast continue? It does. Excellent. Okay, so as long as I keep going, I can keep that thing going all day. Oh, it goes through characters. Time to stretch my legs. Let's turn on Arthas here and see if it actually does go through heroes, not just mercenaries. Because I think I can move through mercenaries just by walking. Yeah, well, now I get a little body blocked. But let's see if I actually move to the other side of Arthas. That'd be pretty huge if I actually could body block him. Oh, it looks like... No, well, hang on. Okay, I do get stuck. Oh, wait, no, I switch. So if I'm right up on his business, it seems like I switch to the other side. Yeah, that's pretty useful. That's body block city right there. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Hmm.
Vicious, don't you think?
That changes my thoughts on Razor Swipe a lot. Good to see you, Papa. Duribo. Zeltok. Rylarian. Good to see you all. Thank you for joining me here today. So, body blocks with some Razor Swipes. Definitely important. Let's take a look at our talents then. Let's get into actually specking this man. Basic attacks lower the cooldown. Each basic attack lowers its cooldown. What? Oh, it's a 16-second cooldown. Gotcha. Well, maybe we should actually toggle off those and actually get a feel for that. All right, so we're fighting, and we mess up. Gotta run. I don't attack anything for 3 seconds, and... What's my auto attack damage? 140 at level 1. That's pretty stellar for my range. Let's see what it's like. 200 augmented. Augmented being the yellow there, meaning it's critting or I'm under the effects of an ability. So I'm apparently under the effects of werewolfism, lycanthropy, when I jump in. 200 damage and auto attack. Mainly I wanted to see what his auto attack damage was to see if he was tuned by his inner beast. That's an excellent attack speed. Yeah, that's stellar. That's Vala levels, but we lose it. You definitely feel that a bit. Okay. So that's not a bad idea. Perfect aim. Increase Gilneas's range and refunds mana against here. Well, I've never really cared too much about refunding mana. The range by 30%, though. Oh, that would be quite a bit. Let's see. Naturally. Interesting. Choose a talent. Perfect aim would make sense if I was up against Novas and I want to knock them out of stealth. But then I have the scented Gilneas cocktail that reveals heroes for 10 seconds. So I can't stack both together. Don't know if I'll be doing perfect aim anytime soon. 60 mana is called? 80 mana. Whoa, that's an expensive spell. Well, let's not use that one too willy-nilly. 70 mana. And 10 mana. Okay, so everything but Dark Flight. 70 mana for that inner beast. So I guess we really want to baby that thing. And make sure we really keep it up. And don't end up losing any of that power. And viciousness. Increase inner beast duration to 4 seconds. And cause the ability to also refresh it. Wait, what? And causes ability damage to also refresh its duration. Interesting. Okay, so one of the first things we observed on this guy was that if I got too caught up using my ult, like go for the throat, or my razor swipe, that I might end up missing my auto attacks and thereby causing the reset of the ability. But will I clear lanes too fast? I don't know. For now, I think we're gonna go with this, because this one here makes up for my mistakes. Let's assume we make no mistakes and we keep it going the entire time. I think viciousness might be the better choice. Let's move onward to level. Oh my, it puts me back at home. I want to go level by level here, though, because I want to feel what the damage actually looks like. I could put myself to 20, but I'd be seeing level 20 values for all these abilities. So, viciousness, I think, is where we're going to end up. Thick skin. Using Dark Flight reduces the damage of your neck made against you by 50% while in Worgen. Oh, okay, so this is my block. Like Morales, I have a block ability at level 4. Interesting. While in Worgen only, though. Eyes in the dark. Disengage grants stealth for 4 seconds. Oh. Inner Beast causes basic attacks to restore mana. Oh, restore 5 mana. Up to 120. Huh. That's interesting that has a maximum. But I guess you could keep it going forever. That's a decent pool of mana, but what? I mean, 5 per attack. Divided by, I mean, that's 20. I'd have to make, so 20 attacks? More than that. I'd have to make a lot of attacks to reach 120 mana. That seems a bit slow. Increase Gilneas Cocktail's explosion length by... Well, I have to hit with it first, don't I? If someone in the chat mentioned that I might run into a talent later that lets my Gilneas Cocktail explode when it hits the ground, but I'm missing a hero there, so why would I take a whole bunch of these abilities and just... Right, beautiful math. I know. Alright, so I don't think I'm not a big fan of Gilneas Cocktail just from the get-go. I think the skill shot is cute, but maybe we'll have to feel it damage-wise. I just think I want to auto-attack as an auto-attack assassin. Could be wrong. Well, seems like it's either thick skin or eyes in the dark. Let's go ahead and try eyes in the dark. Let's see how that feels. So we're in there. We're getting crazy. We're swiping people up and we go, oh no! Okay. Dark light. Let's go. Grand stealth. Disengage. Okay, so I can't jump back in before the stealth is over, so I couldn't reposition myself for anything else. It would absolutely be a disengage. And this is going to be hero dependent. I think we do eyes in the dark here. Just as a general pick. Thick skin is going to be really useful against Rainers. My main problem with block as a talent is it is the job of your supports and burst damage to target enemy heroes with block to get rid of the block so that Rainers can come in and do the serious damage later. Make sense? So I want characters that have bad auto attacks to be engaged with the block heroes. Take those away, and then afterwards, we can get those auto attack assassins in to do all the cleanup. So block, in my opinion, for the longevity of the game, is going to become a bad talent because we will learn how to counter it. Block on Murky, very, very different. You die all the time. Blocking any attacks is going to be a huge decrease in the amount of damage you're taking. You're in lane. That's a unique situation. Morales as well, because she's hidden in the back, but melee assassins and warriors, I think there's plenty of opportunity to ruin good blocks with other characters. So I think I'm going to try Eyes in the Dark. Let's jump up to level 7. Alright, Viciousness, Eyes in the Dark, and we got Quicksilver Bullet. Increase Human's Basic Attack Rate. Oh, this is the one I remember using on the floor at BlizzCon. 20% attack range. Sounded pretty good. Okay. Seems like about the attack range of a Valhalla. And let's see what 20% feels like. Oh. It's a step. Eh. Well, not today then. Maybe if we get into the late game or the level 7. What would that be? The mid game? Early game? And I'm suddenly feeling like I'm not hitting these guys. This is way too dangerous for me to even be in there. Quicksilver Bullet could be what I want to go for. Incendiary Elixir. Deals 200% more damage to the enemy it impacts and explodes even if it misses. Okay, so there is a little bit of reason to take it because of the 200% more damage. Just being double damage, right? 100% more damage would be plus, so if it does 100 damage, we do 150, 200 would be 200. If it did 100, so that's a pretty darn good increase to the enemy it impacts, but that's only going to be one person and then explodes even if it misses, so I'm not taking advantage of it impacts, yeah. So the miss actually wouldn't increase any damage or do anything special for it. Wizen Duelist, hero takedowns increase basic attack damage by 3% for a maximum of 30. This bonus is lost on death. Well, certainly Lost Vikings, Murky, those sort of guys we're going to get a hold of a lot. I think we go with this one. I don't think it's as dangerous as Gathered Power because we have Eyes in the Dark. I mean, people are still going to see Wizen Duelist in the long run, of course, and come to kill me and clean me up and stop it. But I think Wizen Duelist is where we'll see if we can catapult ourselves to victory. Let's jump up to 10. I have a pretty strong opinion about what I'm going to go with for 10, but let's go ahead and read through them here. Go for the throat, eviscerate a hero, refreshing its cooldown if they die. Leap towards a hero, dealing 555 damage, that's pretty decent. If it kills, the ability can be used a second time within 10 seconds. Interesting. If it kills them, the ability can be used a second time within 10 seconds for free. That's different than it was on the BlizzCon floor. At BlizzCon, it was actually just, it can be reused. There was no sort of changes to it. So if the whole enemy team could be killed by Go for Throat, you could just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 across all of them. Looks like we're limited, but let's test the enemy heroes. Okay, never mind then. Within 10 seconds. Expensive spell, 90 mana on a melee assassin. No area effect either, so I'll have to make sure I actually have enough mana to pull this off when I get to it. Marked for the kill. Shapeshift into... Oh, what? I turned into a worgen. Shapeshift into a human and fire a shot, hitting the first enemy hero for damage. A lot less damage. For 5 seconds, they are vulnerable, which is pretty long vulnerable. Taking 25% increased damage, and you can reactivate this to leap at them as a shapeshift worgen. Interesting that I turn into a human. This is a skill shot, though, and I'm very nervous about missing this. It's so thin. I mean, imagine if Jaina had Frostbolt as an ultimate, and it all lands on just this. But let's... Whoopsies. Pardon me. Sorry, guys. Let's see if we... Well, that is rather stellar range. A bit slow moving, though, isn't it? So how was that attack different from what I normally do? Because I normally leap with a much... Okay, and then I leap, and... And then I can disengage. And I can leap at that range, and I can disengage. And with this guy, I can shoot... Oh. Leap at them, and shapeshift into a worgen. Oh. Wait a minute, this could change a lot. So if I hit this, and then I go... I don't know, go hit a well or something. But I hold on to it. That changes a ton. Whoa, that's really different. Okay, on paper, this thing... That... Cause what if I miss the skill shot? Then I get nothing. And I'm stuck waiting 60 seconds? Let's turn off that toggle cooldown. Yeah. Oh, and it's kind of slow moving, too. But if I hit it, oh, and I can mount up, and I could run for it, and then be like, surprise! That's pretty neat. Okay. I still have to hit this bullet, though, in the first place, though. And that's gonna be difficult. I think we're gonna go with
choose a talent.
Viciousness, Eyes in the Dark, Wise and Duelist. I think we're gonna go for the throat for now. Because Marked for the Kill is gonna be a skill, 100%. I know it's an increased damage, they can get deleted in the current meta. Vulnerability is a huge deal. Despite Tyrande, who gets a vulnerability at level 1, most other heroes only get vulnerability at level 16. So this is a pretty big deal to get it at 10, and you could really destroy... Actually, let's give it one more go. Let's see what the damage is on this land, or do I just leap to them? Alright, 65% damage. Dealing quite a bit of extra damage there. Vulnerable, auto attacks. Oh, but I turned back into a human, that's right. Okay. I hit him, jump to him. 357. And what's this do otherwise? Down to 35. I think that's the plan. So in the long run, I think we absolutely are going to be needing to go Marked for the Kill. It's going to be an extremely learned skill. I don't think we're going to be mastering that anytime today. So let's stick with Viciousness, Eyes in the Dark, Wise and Duelist, Go for the Throat. Just for simplicity, a much simpler ability. I jump exactly what I want to, and I can be human for it, right? Yep. And then I turn into a worgen. Much bigger reduced range, but still... Ooh, I like that scream on it. That's a cool sound. Alright, let's jump up to level 13. In the long run, precast W. Good point. I do need to make sure I'm putting out W before I do any sort of leap in. Balancing that W is going to be a bit of a rough cake. But, you know, with Inspire, I think I might be able to pull it off. I might have the skill set for it. Let's check out our 13. Viciousness. Eyes in the dark. Wizen Duelist. Go for the throat. With the plan to go to Marked for the Kill in the long run, because that was incredible. I've been playing a lot of Tyrael recently, too, and this creativity of hitting someone with ability, wandering off in a different direction, and then jumping back on them really just takes some people off their guard, and I love it. It's such a creative way to use it. Spirited, as I often call it. So, Marked for the Kill, I think, is where we're going in the long run. Anyway, Running Wild, increased dark flights and disengage rain by 35%. Well, you know, that'd be decent. Let's take a look. That's pretty big. And if I do disengage, well, disengage didn't feel quite as huge. But it's range. So I don't really want to bother myself with too many range talents, as I can just counter them by being in good positions. And plus, I will probably have a larger chance to dive too deep and end up getting killed. Keeping my range short, at least for the beginning, will give me a good understanding of what I can actually accomplish. And this is level 13, so let's not get married to any range talents and get dependent on them to perform our skills. Happens a lot with characters like Kael'thas. Lots of Kael'thas out there wandering around laying bombs like they have living bomb the entire time. And they're actually really bad Kael'thas until level 13. Same goes with hammers. Lots of really bad hammers out there who become good when they get Hover Siege. But that's a long time to wait to become a good hammer. Worgen's basic attacks reduce Razor Swipe's cooldown by 1 second. Alright. Razor Swipe. Oh. Nope. Yes. Okay. Gotta jump. 3 seconds. Oh. Toggle cooldowns. Oh, I didn't take the talent. Let's do the talent. Okay. Well, only 30 mana too. I mean, that's pretty cool, but in the line of combat, even with stutter stepping and great basic attacks, actually, I don't know. Actually, that changes a lot, doesn't it? Because if I'm making good basic attacks, I have body blocks, I'm where I need to be, I'm attacking the entire time. This could actually add a huge amount of DPS and will position me forward constantly. So not only am I doing, you know, like a stutter step around them, which will be different once this is open. Yeah. So I'm stutter stepping around my target, and as they run, not only am I stutter stepping with them, but I can take these extra steps and keep going auto attack, stutter step, dive, stutter step, dive.
Choose a talent.
That could be pretty good. But do I need to stutter step? Should I be concerned about keeping up with my targets when I have go for the throat and a leap? I can also use disengage aggressively. I don't have to use disengage to get away. I can absolutely just move with them and attack them as they walk by me, then leap to them as they move this way and keep going. So maybe not essential. Pretty cool though. And with a mana cost of only 30, there's plenty of excuse to spam that ability. On the prowl. Inner Beast increases your movement speed by 30% once it has been activated for 3 seconds. Interesting. All right, looks like we got to try out all these. So, we've been a beast for a bit. We've been a beast, and... Did I do it wrong? Oh, Inner Beast the ability, not that I become a beast. Okay, so Inner Beast, we're Inner Beasting. And, okay, yeah. Could help me keep Inner Beast going by closing up to my next target. But we'll see.
Choose a talent.
I hear Goldrin's howl.
Increase Razor Stripe's range, but increase its cooldown. Lunges. Ah, interesting. Lunges him 60% farther. But its cooldown is increased by 33%, which would be one additional second. And we can't pick both of these. Ah, clever Blizzard. Stopping me from stacking the talents I want. Hey, oh.
This is my
look at that way he stands. What a gentleman. That's a great passive. What actually is his mount up? Oh, he slicks back his hair. That's pretty cool.
I will not accept defeat.
All right, well, let's feel that out, because I think we're starting to discover... And he spins his little gun. That's cute. All right, I think we're starting to discover that Razor Swipes is going to be an amazing ability for body blocking. So we jump in. We got our Razor Swipes. Wow. All right, let's get Arthas out here. Let's see what we can do against old Arthy Poo. Yeah, so the it will be increased, which means, so if we have it 1 second sooner, will we move further? Oh, I summoned my ally, never mind. Will we move 1 second sooner, meaning we keep up on them that much, and the talent we picked for increasing the lunge by 60% doesn't even matter. It could. I mean, certainly it's going to help a lot, like if I jump here, and I'm really concerned about hitting all these minions, right? Makes it very easy to get to the side. I don't even really have to close that distance. I am absolutely 100% to the side of this guy. Let's see if we can get Arthas to run away. And we'll get in front of him. Mmm. So I think that ability will actually be better for people who aren't good at stutter stepping already. With a decreased cooldown of 1 second, I can accomplish this anyway. And I have Gilneas Cocktail. It's decently expensive, so maybe I need to save that, and Razor Swipe here at level 13 will just be a better lane clear regardless. But I think I can skip it. This is what I'm really excited about with this stealth too, is if you can bolt into a bush, then you get to do that sweet just sort of straight up disappear. That doesn't make me keep up on him. I think we're just going to have to try that out. I don't think we're going to be able to decide here. Yeah, it does feel like a really long time.
Choose a talent.
I feel like we got through the rest of these pretty easily, but this level's certainly giving me some thought. I think we're going to try visceral attacks, first to see how that goes, and if we can just stutter step and make up for all the problems we might have. Plus, with disengage, we can absolutely keep up on them. Unfettered Assault will do if people are just getting away, and that little bit of dash could absolutely. Swipe resets inner beast. What? Does it?
Time to stretch my leg.
And causes abilities to also refresh it. Right, that's what you were talking about? Because I took this talent here? So I am keeping inner beast up. Alright, I'm going to do... Yeah, I think I'm going to go with this visceral attacks for now. A little bit of battle momentum. Just a tiny one for myself. Let's go ahead and set that level up. Let's get our 16. Viciousness. Eyes in the dark. Wise and duelist. Go for the throat. And visceral attacks. All right, here we are. Here's that alpha killer I talked about so much over the past. Basic attacks against heroes deal damage equal to 3% of the hero's maximum health while in worgen form. This is our giant killer, but doesn't go away after 3 swipes like Artanis. As long as you are a worgen, you will be doing some killing. Executioner, interesting. Absolutely a good pick if we have ourselves a Jaina or a Thrall we could combo with. Relentless Predator. Reduce the duration of silences, stuns, slows. Okay, so this is your Relentless. While in worgen form. Concentrated Blast. Increase Gilneas' Cocktail's damage by 80% while Inner Beast is active. Interesting. You know, because I don't think I'm going to have any trouble keeping Inner Beast active outside of, you know, it going off cooldown when the lane is pushed out or I have to run away. But just in general like this, I don't think I'm going to have any trouble doing it. Even if I throw a cocktail, I don't need it to reset the cooldown. Because I can just keep auto-attacking. So I don't think I need this ability. There are some decent excuses here to build a really good, really complex Gilneas cocktail build. Explosion length. We go with the decrease mana, you get the mana back at 80 mana. Yeah, only spending 20 there will be really useful. Dealing bonus damage. But for now, let's invest in the Worgen. As we've gone forward, has this changed at all? Damage, mana, nope. Cool. So I think we'll be needing Relentless, because we're going to get stunned when we jump in. And reducing that by 75% is a big, big deal. Nothing makes Relentless more clear than playing a lot of Monk, because you got a punch to heal. If you're getting stunned for too long, you're not going to be able to do much. I agree about the... Yeah, this is the right pick for the meta right now. And if I dive in and I instantly explode, what good was I? Here I can actually get out. I have a stealth on my disengage, but I do have to survive for 6 seconds in there before I can disengage. So would this help me survive it? Probably. Executioner, if we come across it. Alpha killer. So some really great key choices based on what's happening in our map here. I think we'll end up going Relentless Predator just for muscle memory clicking for now. But I think we could really make any of those good choices at this current point in the meta. Let's jump up to 20 and grab our final talent here before we jump into the AI game. Viciousness. Eyes in the dark. Wise and Duelist. Go for the throat. Visceral. Relentless. Unleash. Free cast kills also gives free cast. Okay. So this is the whole team kill magical Christmas situation that Blizzard has given us. If my free cast for Go to the Throat hits its target, what? Kills its target. Okay, not hits. Okay, woo, that's a big deal. All right, because if it hits, yes, it's going to hit its target. Why wouldn't it? We just have to make sure we kill the first guy and then we can use it forever? You're insane, Blizzard. But no, I'm just misreading. We're good to go. We do have two other talents, actually, and they look unique. Hunter's Blunderbuss. Basic attacks splash for 100% of the damage behind the target. Ah, some Baylog action. Making some nice straight lines. This is a lot like Assassin from Dota. Interesting. And I'm talking about the one that goes invisible and lays a little traps. Not Phantom Assassin in Dota. That's cool. Let's see. I want to see this in action. But let's read the other one first. Basic attack cleave. Ah, Gilneas Roulette. Marked for the kill, passes through enemy heroes, making them all vulnerable and allowing leap to be used on each marked hero target once. Closest target is preferred. Once? Wait, target once? Okay, wait, hang on. Wait, okay, no. All right. Whoa, okay. Viciousness. Mark for kill. If that's true, then we might actually start with mark to the kill, see what we can pull off, get some good practice in with it, and then at level 20, we have a pretty big safety net for this. Am I reading this correct? So if I line this up and I shoot these giants, toggle cooldowns. If I hit these giants, okay, if I hit these giants... Oh, wait, no, I'm just... okay, I'm not insane. It's just passing through them. First hero. Oh, this guy counts as a hero. And it passes through. Well, bummer. That's not going to tell me what I want to know. I want to know if I have two heroes, do I jump from each one to the next? Because it says... Allowing leap to be used on each marked target once. Closest target is preferred. So, if I were to hit two targets in a line, hero one is closest to me, hero two runs away, I jump to the first hero, and I have another cast of my leap available to the second hero? Is that what I'm reading? Because that's insane. And I can accomplish basically what Go for the Throat is doing if I get a kill. All right. Well, I need to test that out. Okay, so I'm reading that correctly. That's a pretty big deal, and that is a lot more powerful than Unleashed. Basic attack splash, I like this. We're definitely going to have a nice human build we can do if we are falling behind. That's one of my favorite things about my theory crafting for Greymane, is that if we are entirely behind, we are being pushed to our gates, we'll be able to do a lot more than someone like a Butcher. Thrall has great ping already, so I think Thrall can manage to keep up casting lightnings over the wall, some chain lightnings, and keeping the game going, but that's what I'm really excited about with Greymane here. So this could be a decent pick. And Cleave is pretty cute, but we're going to be doing so many of these slash attacks, I don't think we need to cleave anything else in the area, but it is 100% of the basic attack damage if two heroes are touching each other. Well, it really comes down to how big that cleave is. But I think we've discovered we're going to try out this Glenaeus roulette. Let's go ahead and jump into an AI game here, and we'll see if we can line up two heroes and get an idea of what that actually comes out to be. Let's jump into a custom game. Let's do something nice and laney. Let's go ahead. We'll jump into Dragonshire here. When I jump to the target, it is marked by the vulnerability, so that vulnerability doesn't go away. Let's set these guys to Adept. We are a melee assassin. Elite computers are really great if you're learning how to tank or you're learning to support. I definitely suggest doing it against elites there, because at about the 7-minute mark, computers in elite mode just group up and never let go. It's very hard to be an assassin practicing any sort of ganks in there because those computers are so tight together. Where are you at? Oh, it's the wolf face. Interesting. All right, let's roll. Oh, and he turns into a wolf when... Yeah, that's cute. I like it. Right, they're both vulnerable at level 20. The bullet passes through them. This is what we're theorizing right now. And then they will both have a leapable mark on them once. I leap to them, still vulnerable. Doesn't take away that debuff. And I can leap to the second one I hit. Still marked, doesn't have the debuff. But if I leap each time, is the timer still ticking? Or does it refresh? That'd be very different. Of course, the vulnerability will have its own duration of only 4 seconds. That'll be burning the entire time. Quite the little team I have here. Morales, Arthas, Jaina, Nazebo, and Sylvanas on the enemy team. Battle commencing in. So against that team, do I change anything? Duration of 4 seconds. Reveals heroes. Five, nope, I don't need reveals four, heroes. Three. Two, one. This could be what I want in the long run, though. I don't need the abilities also refresh. So I think Wolfheart might be what I'm going for eventually, but I feel like Wolfheart is giving me a buffer to things that I will screw up, whereas Viciousness is rewarding my own continued play. Let's see what happens. We got a Gazlo. Enemy Jaina. Oh, no need to be scared. We got range damage. Hey, well, that looks like some pretty decent damage anyway. Expensive spell for sure. The ancient shrines awake. Make a nice straight line here. Control them and let loose the Dragon Knight. No need for me to take those attacks. I have disengage on... Oh no, I have to be a wolf to disengage, don't I? That's so disappointing when it doesn't hit anything. Alright, well, let's see if we can go on Sylvanas here. That went well on a hero who was running a little late. Activate the shrines and the dragon's power. I don't think that's a very accurate representation, but seems to be going well. The computers aren't undertuned or missing any life at this level, so. It looks like Asmodan's gonna take top for us, so I can just wait here. As much as I want to experiment, a bit of a waste of time riding the dragon, but we'll stop a computer from riding it. Probably a good idea. And no one's gonna come to stop me at this difficulty? Well, that's just dandy. I am forgetting W. You're absolutely correct. I did not use my inner beast once there. But we're gonna do that Eyes in the Dark for now. Well, we're just gonna get the whole boring duration of this thing, aren't we? Oh, getting hit by the ice. And just dis- oh, right. I have to be a wolf to disengage. That's gonna be rough. And I have to leap to an enemy target. All right, let's get some inner beast going. Oh, nope, looks like I'm mid. Okay. And how do I get my health back? I don't have any abilities to regenerate any sort of health. Not even on an ultimate or anything. All right, let's stack ourselves some inner beast. And she ran, and what, maybe we can dark leap to this? Yeah, we'll keep the inner beast going, all right. Don't destroy walls when you have a gray mane on your team. They need them. Nope. Need to go to the wall. And keep it going. Oh, nope, that's such disappointment. Probably leap to Jaina. I think that would get me killed. Oh, wait, we can keep it going. We don't have to lose it. We don't have to lose it. We can stutter step with this. Alright, Wizened Duelist. Human basic attack range. Yeah, we don't need any of these sort of emergency talents. Alright, what? I've got no targets. Oh, okay. And then I have to wait. Is that... So I would have it ready yet again if I took the level 1 talent. I took the Wolfheart talent, that would absolutely be ready for me in the background. Is that too damaging to wait 16 seconds on an attack like that? I do not know. It's a decent way, just doesn't feel like it does enough for the mana cost. Not like, I'm really not having any mana issues, am I? But I guess I'm also doing a good job keeping Inner Beast going. Inner Beast could get really expensive. Actually, that may be the crux there. If I had Wolfheart, would I be spending too much mana? Let me handle this. Let's go get ourselves a Nazeba. We do have Wolfheart after all. We need to get some kills. Okay, he's not there. That's so disappointing. Oh, Wolfheart. I mean, whatever it's called. Inner Beast. Boy, that step forward's gonna make Stutter Step easy. Oh my goodness.
Is a hunt.
If they get it, that's totally my fault. I love that. Oh, that slick back is fantastic. Thank you, Gazlu. Let's see how we do against Arthas at half health. But, you know, shouldn't matter.
No more holding back.
Oh, if he outdistances me. Ah, that 20% range would be nice, wouldn't it? Let's see if we can get a computer to ride the dragon. I'm not here to ride dragons. I'm here to leap characters and inner beast, and I'm all out of inner beast. Oops. Oh, that was a Rhaegar heal. Okay, nothing magical happened there. Gosh, my health feels tiny. Let's go marked for the kill. Let's go marked for the kill. Let's see what we can do against some squishies. Looks like there's... Yeah, we got Team Ice in the bottom. Though, we should probably go guard that mid. As we are 3 levels ahead, this is a pretty poor representation of what my damage will actually feel like out on the field. I should feel incredible. But let's see what we can make happen. So right now this hits the first hero. So I don't need to worry about minions, which is good. But I do need to worry, so I can fire through minions. Gotta make sure I want the hero I want though. Let's see if we can get Jaina. Alright. Oh, I'm 3 levels up, so I don't think that's an accurate representation of what I'll actually be able to do, but holy heck. That's pretty awesome. And we got 3 stacks, so hey, oh, that's 9%. Wow, that stacks up quick. No quicker than gathering power, but still. Let's go top and see what we can make happen. Oh, Archer. Ruining my day. What, we got an Azebo making his way?
Absolutely.
I need stacks, yo. Where you at, Zeebs? Aw, he knows. He knows to get it.
No escape.
Disengage 6 seconds. You can really feel it now. Alright, I've got no health. But 7 seconds left on my mark for the kill. So, you know, oh, there's Rhaegar. Cool.
Much appreciated.
See? Oh! I didn't even need it. But missing that ability is going to suck.
Most assuredly.
And our healer is inside the dragon. Alright, here we're talking about visceral attacks. Has anything changed? No. Not really. No. Oh, Ravaging Spirit. 10 seconds till my bullet. Oh, and they're coming in a little strong. If they chase, though, I've got my bullet. No, I don't really want to jump into that, despite my 3 levels. Let's make smart calls. And Computer Arthas, nice dragon there. See if we can get Sylvanas. Oh, nope, 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 nope. Oh, my stacks. All right, well, even at 3 levels, woof. 4 heroes, so 4v1. You can't do it. Sorry to say. Yeah, I'm really feeling that. Yeah, Grey Maiden is... He's got a tiny health pool, doesn't he? It'd be nice to get back. Yeah, right, exactly. You saw it here first. Grey Maiden needs a buff. Can't beat AI Adepts all by himself. What is this? Top siege damage for some reason. Oh, because I rode the dragon. Gotcha. It's like, I'm not doing that much. I'm not spending too much time in lane. Looks like these two parties are just going to dodge each other, so we'll assist our computers here.
Unleash the dragon's wrath.
He's such a great laner, you know? He's going to have really great dueling capabilities. One-on-one, I think he'll win most fights. But, so if this was another MOBA, I would say, holy crap, this character probably going to be a little OP. But this is a team game. We can jump on Morales here, but... Oh, that disengage takes forever! Good to know, though. Good to feel out. Getting slowed for sure. Yeah, no point for the giant killer. I'm enjoying Grey Maiden so far, Azex. Experimenting with what sort of bites I can take out of a team. Diving in 1v4 didn't work. Diving in 1v5 didn't work, so we've established that much. There really isn't too much surprise there. I don't think the block would be helping me out in that situation. Relentless will help me out getting away from the Jaina and getting out of Arthas' route, so there's some good excuse for the Relentless one. I think that'll be our go-to pick if nothing else really looks too good. Oh, if they die, I don't get to use it. If they are dead, I cannot leap.
Time to stretch my legs.
Gotta keep those stacks going. Stack's still going. Mmm. That increased range, though. If they're running away, I kind of need that to actually deliver the auto, but that's on a different level, so it doesn't really matter. Oh, he uses a sword in melee. Nice. Alright, I got no time. Aww. The 15 seconds of shame. 7 seconds, though. This thing, even with a minute-long cooldown, feels like it's coming up pretty quick. What's a viscerate? Also 6 seconds. Okay. So no benefits there. And then we wander off, and we're like, oh no, we're letting her get away. Actually, probably shouldn't do that. Need to take full advantage of the... Oh! Dragon! What? Oh, well, I guess we'll just win the game. .322 at this level. Let's see what Wolf looks like. .450. Wow, quite a bit of extra damage. Oh, no targets in line. Boy, that attack speed feels slow when you come off of Inner Beast. And that doesn't slow or anything, does it? No, that just explodes. So he's got 0 CC on him. Acceptable for an assassin, of course. Giving an assassin CC. It's kind of the reason why we have things like Jaina and Kael'thas dominating the meta right now.
The future belongs to those who take it.
That top NA Diablo, man. He's too good. If he had kicked him first and then I left after him using the bullet ability marked for the kill, then that could be interesting. All right, looks like we have a... Oh, jeez. That's going to be punishing. I can leap this way, though. Okay. I like the swipe cooldown as well because it gives me that extra second, too, that I can use it as a disengage. But let's hold out for the real question we're trying to figure out here, if hitting two heroes with this allows me two leaps. Sounds like it does. If I hit five heroes, do I get five leaps then?
Awaken once more. Who will control the Dragon Knight's power?
It's like they're going for it. Diablo's gonna get himself killed. That was a great grenade by Computer Morales. We just need a bit of XP, guys. I'm gonna go farm. All right, here we go. Pierce's heroes. Let's hit two, shall we? Or five. All right, one, two, three. All right. So now we know. When I leap to them, shapeshift into a worgen. It did minimal damage. When I tried it out in the try mode, it said about 69. So it's not a lot. But that does mean both Marked for the Kill and my Go for the Throat have basically the exact same applications. I'm using it to destroy an enemy team that would otherwise get away. Well, damn. With that level 20 augmentation in mind, and these two being okay, but, I mean, I'll be swiping so much in worgen form. I don't really need the splash damage. And then human form, this is a good emergency pick. But I think we just need to train ourselves up for Marked for the Kill. Yeah, exactly. And Go for the Throat, while extremely neat and probably our preferred, easier ability, I think we're just going to go Marked for the Kill from now on.
Fail my people again.
We need to get this guy on a nice horse. He can't be riding this undecorated. I mean, he's a faction leader, after all. Oh, you know what? I got a horde wolf he can ride. Is that weird? Is it weird to put a werewolf on a wolf?
It's about time we took a mercenary camp.
Sure, that sounds good. Oh, look at the minimap. So he actually permanently shows up as Worgen form on the minimap. I guess it doesn't affect too much. It's still interesting that they didn't choose to differentiate each other from it. Let's see if my team here will leave me alone long enough to try taking a mercenary camp all by myself. Nope. Kind of like Vala. I can absolutely do it. I would make it through it, but you just walk out with too much health missing. And if I didn't have a healer here like Rhaegar, I'd be stuck hearthing all the way back, so let's not solo any mercenary camps on Greymane. This thing. Enemy hits. Okay, cool. So if I do a wall... Yeah. I like that. That has good applications for siege damage. Let's get uppity. Okay, no, I only have the duration of the ability to kill everybody. So I do not get any favors done for me with that leap. I only have the one duration to use it in. Oh, 6 seconds feels like such a long time. Well, the computers... I mean, I did the work, right? I killed 3 of them. Computers can do the rest, surely, right? Asmodan, lock on your laser. Asmodan. Hand up, you know? Bust it out, dude. If you do it, no. We're gonna be waiting. Gazlo is hearthing back. Oh, wait. Nope, not today. Right, well, you gotta match them out, you know? That lion is silly. Big top skins. I'm glad people enjoy them. Not for me. I like to play serious-looking serious men. Though I might put a serious-looking guy on a rainbow goat every once in a while. Just to mix things up. Just some bad manners. Yelling at your teammates just to give you the authentic experience. Let's see if we can get Gazlo to help us out with this. And if not, we'll hijack his AI and make him help us. Nope. Let's see if we can get ourselves a kill. Nobody up here. Oh, wait, there's someone. It's Zeebo. Should have waited to use the leap until I actually needed it. But I guess once I, with a mark for the kill, I can use the leap whenever I want. Oh, can I? No, it's a little short range to leap the wall. Oof. Vulnerability. Running wild. But I did have to use it on a single target, which decreases some of its value. No quarter. Come on. Oh, no. Nope. Oh, pardon me, Arthas. Thank goodness for Relentless. Oh, dear. Oh, that's not a good move. Oof. Low health Greymane is a careful thing. Alright. I think we made it through that pretty well. I wish I could have made Heroes Rising. Pretty close after BlizzCon still, so did not make the trick. And plus, hey, who knows if that event was going to go off like it was. Like I mentioned in the last ITN, there have been a lot of failed esports events over the years. I am overjoyed that esports rising went as well for both the company in the future, but also the casters, for people like, you know, DJ Tyrant. Like, that's great. That's awesome. I am so happy for that guy. He's got a meme. He's going to go far now because people remember exactly who he is with hashtag stay tight. He might be as embarrassed as hell about that particular situation, but he shouldn't be. He should be very, very proud of his performance and the fact that he let loose a meme on the community, that will keep him in our minds and hearts for future jobs. Did they have a lot of issues the first day? I believe it. I recorded the replay episode Saturday morning, and people were being like, "What? Don't you love esports, Kyle? You're betraying your..." And I'm like, guys, it's the first time running a tournament. I don't think you understand how many hangups they're going to be getting into these matches. They're going to be late. They're going to be running late. Who knows what else they could run into. So it was a perfectly safe time for those games to happen. The reverse draft was awesome. In fact, if you are a patron this Thursday, we'll be doing a reverse draft for our after show games, because that was one of my favorite things I have ever seen. What a great event they put together for that. So that was a good call. Let's see if we could do it against the full blown computers, and let's get ourselves let's do another lane map. Actually, I'm kind of curious about Infernal Shrines. Characters with area effects will always be a little more powerful on Infernal Shrines. And he's got Swipe, which could do a lot, particularly with that decreased cooldown as we reach the higher levels. So let's see. Let's take on some elites. Let's trust our healers, and hopefully they'll save our buns. And then we'll get into a quick match game. And that's something that's gonna... That's just growing pains, you know, making sure... And it's a budgeting thing, too. You gotta make sure you have the budget to hire that many casters. Oh, no, did they? That's hilarious. That's a great mistake to make the mic. You know, and you gotta mic the crowd. The winning celebration was a little lackluster, and that's just gonna happen with smaller tournaments. Miking the crowd is an overwhelmingly important thing that most first-time tournaments forget about. And it matters a lot. It's how all the players watching at home perceive the live event to be. And if you don't mic that crowd, you're going to have, like, one scream cannon, someone who can really pump it out there, and you're like, woo! But other than that, it sounds like there's two people in the audience. Oh, something like charging players for water. That is a bit of an oversight, you know, and that'll come with experience. But that location also needed to be paid. And, you know, you can't skimp on concessions. And that's actually how a lot of those locations that host those events make their real money. I mean, you can rent out any building you want for a pretty decent price, but you want to fill it with food and people. That's what's really going to cost you. I think let's try out that Wolfheart this time. I think we did a really good job. I think the extra second on this made it a lot easier. But, you know, maybe it is actually this ability, and the other one is the crutch. Having that extra second to actually complete it, and abilities that can pull it off as well. And my timer does go so fast, but it's only on a 2-second cooldown. Maybe we'll run into some mana issues with this thing too, and we'll learn a bit about ourselves as well. Well, Hammer seems to have this on lockdown. Let's go visit mid. Hammer is unsieged, so good opportunity to jump in, get a little crazy. All right. Nope. Actually, let's just stay crazy. There's no point in running away because we can disengage and blow up. That goes fast, doesn't it? But if you have disengage, walking away is a disservice to your DPS. Hammer here, too. Might want to take that thick skin instead of eyes in the dark with a hammer on the field.
I fight for my countrymen.
There's a Jaina. I think she'll be dead. What? They're gonna let her get away? Alright. Wait, oh no, oh no. Looks like we're just letting her get away. Oh well, we can go on Diablo, I guess. Inner beast, I need inner beast. Lost it, but only, again, a 3 second cooldown. I can be interrupted mid-leap. Oh, the crits. So my Worgen leap is not unstoppable. So I can be totally pushed back. I can be stunned mid-air. A lot can go wrong in there. And they're all up too, aren't they? Well, let's be good little goobers and not leap in. Let's use our bullets. Oh. Alright, I guess I should hearth back. Let's try that. I don't know. For Hammer, do I want stealth, where I will disengage and be invisible and won't be able to be attacked by her auto attacks that are now in range? Or do I want thick skin, so I never took that much damage in the first place, ended up surviving long enough to use disengage? I guess we'll want thick skin. Let's try that out. Anubrak getting himself skill. Oh my goodness. This is what I'm talking about. They're really balled up. A bit more realistic of a situation, though. Ouch. Does pretty decent damage. If I need to do a full human build. But have I gone too deep to do a full human build at this point? And that's gonna be ruined, and I gotta wait the full duration again. Oh dear. We have slain the enemy's Punisher. Oh no, 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 grab me, Diablo. That's a tight team. So is Diablo my primary concern? And Lili. So is the Diablo, the Lili with the wins, and the Diablo with two stuns, is that a complete counter to my wolf, and I need to just invest entirely into being human? Did I mess up by not taking perfect aim early on? No, I think Inner Beast is still a good call. I think this is a very safe talent. Thick skin, though. Maybe I should have gone with that wrath. It's just explosion length. Okay. It's like my team's not with me, so let's not bite off. That looks like they're going for, yep, some mercenaries. We'll help them out so they get back on the field faster. I guess we won't use Inner Beast. Well, how many auto attacks have I made? That's 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so I'd only have a 5-second cooldown. That would have been perfectly acceptable to use there. They just can't be little lane clear fights, or I'll end up with a longer cooldown than it's worth. They're a little entrenched, but Anubrak's going for it. The reason I'm commentating like this is because it's, like I said before, it's very important that you act like your AIs are real people. Otherwise, you'll just disrespect them and you'll learn nothing. So we need to make sure this is actually... Maybe I should have gone in earlier. Now that they're all dead, there's nothing I can really do to help them out. So, Wizen Duelist probably not going to actually get in there enough to get those kills I would want. They're pretty tanky. So I guess let's do Quicksilver Bullets. Alright, Anubrak's making the call. Aw, misclick lets Computer Diablo get away. It's Stutter stepping is really easy on this guy, though. No, don't kill them all. I need... Actually, I don't, do I? Alright, that went well. Oh yeah, we're keeping it going. There we go, okay. One more, nope. Keep it going. Keep inner beast going. We lost it, and it got it right back. Damn, that Talon's cool. And I'm running actually a little low on mana, but I don't think any worse than any other assassin. Kerrigan would be completely at this point, so I don't think I'm limited by my mana here. And we'll keep up on that mark for the kill. It's easy to forget, though, when you're in there as human form that you don't have disengage to roll away with. It's probably going to be the toughest part. And I am actually running out of mana. Really love the relocation of the Razor Swipe, though. Alright, everything missing, everything res. Let's get out of here. Even if it's just a computer. Computer Diablo might still know how to pick you up over the wall. Nope, looks like they're all balled up top there.
Most assuredly.
These mercenaries will serve us well.
Alright, well that's the call they're making. Let's go join them. Ooh. For what it's worth in an AI game.
To victory.
Guess we'll leap over this wall. And as long as I make, what, even 5 auto attacks, it's worth it? 13 seconds?
Excellent work.
It's a bit of a long cooldown, but still not 16 seconds. ...20% range increase isn't a lot, but it does put you over the point. Actually, I'd have to check his range, but it feels like his range is right on par with Vala, which means a 20% increase would be enough to just outdistance her barely. That's the same range as Tychus, Lunara. Most range heroes have the exact same range on them. So 20% would actually keep you safe. I don't really want to use my killing shot on Diablo, but... Done that. Should have just stayed Worgen. There's a lot of DPS. So let's see here. Disengage range. That could be good, given the situation of what we keep running into. We're also... You know what? Let's try out that unfettered assault for those body blocks as guys start to run away. I want to see that in a more real-world situation. Diablo wants me. Retribution is at hand. Alright. That felt cool. Still really low health. Let's see if Malfurion can heal me up. Nice. Did Malfurion go silence all? He did. Malfurion. Tempting. Tempting to jump a wall as always. But let's not. Not getting Thrall out today. But we can make a nice straight line for the explosion, which takes up almost the entirety of the building. So the explosion is not larger on the other side, nor does it come out the other side of the building, like you might think. Okay, it looks like we're getting out of here.
Let me handle this.
So in this case, well, we've had the Diablo problems. We've had the Diablo problems, so Relentless is not a bad idea. We don't really have any reason to take Executioner. And, well, with the Diablo on the field, there's always a choice of Alpha Killer. But let's go ahead and we'll just play it safe. Woo. Tried to disengage. I'm not a wolf. I did not disengage. Diablo wants to make it happen. I think we can absolutely abide him. Definitely tore through quite a bit of his health. It's like Thrall's back. Malfurion has no mana. Malfurion, you have no mana! What are you doing? You're oom. Stop this. Alright, well, we're gonna keep it going. Hey, that's fine. I wanna know about. Oh. Oh, no! My inner fire! Oh wait, I got it going. Nope. Oh my goodness.
The shrine is ready. Go to and claim the Punisher's power for the high heavens.
The cocktail damage. Hurl a flask dealing quite a bit of damage to the targets behind them. 403 actually. So that's why the talent increase doubles the damage of the initial hit, but does not increase the damage of the back splash. And that splash is not large enough to hit a building and explode very far behind it. So really shouldn't be used in any sort of siege situation.
I fight for my countrymen.
Morgan feels so slow without that inner beast going. Oh no, I did the wrong ability. I disengaged when I meant to dark flight. Not like that's happening anywhere online right now today. I meant to leap, not roll and become human. Which of course meant I lost my block. Reduce the duration of your next two. Using dark flight reduces the damage done to you by. So actually, I only get block for when I go into dark flight. If I'm hanging out in Worgen too long, thick skin isn't doing anything for me because it never regenerates. Not like Eyes in the Dark does anything for me if I don't turn back into a human and I stay as a Worgen. Just an interesting note to be made. And still no real mana issues, but that's the talent I can counter that with if it comes along. It's still not very big though. Explosion length. Might be an excuse to take it. Oh, Stimbone would be amazing. Stimdrome, not bone. Oh, they're all dead. Yep, now they're all dead. I guess we'll go win this one.
Let me handle this.
Wow, Wow, they're really BMing that computer team. Some computer on computer BM here. Yeah, GG computers. Nice job. That sweet stim bone. Gotta watch out for it. It does feel like it has quite a bit of support. Let's check, actually. Let's see. I mean, just on paper, let's see what we can actually accomplish. So, range and mana refunded. That's the tough part, is I need to make a level one choice as to what I want. And I will always be using Inner Beast. So these talents are really, really safe. I think Wolfheart did the business. If I was in a double support situation, maybe Viciousness, because I'll burn through all my mana because I'll keep living for so long, but I think Wolfheart's where it's at. Perfect. So I increase the range by 30.36% and get, and if I hit, of course, I only spend 20 mana casting it. Then we go into increase the explosion length range, so not the length of the explosion, by 35%. Not a huge amount, but decent. Deals 200% more damage to the enemy it hits and explodes even if it misses. So if you hit an enemy, you'll do the bonus damage of, what, so 300 damage at level 1. And explodes even if it misses, meaning you could miss on purpose. Oh, okay. So if I'm going to miss on purpose in order to take advantage of the really big damage, that isn't even anywhere close to double damage on the initial hit. Just that after explosion, so much better. I wouldn't really want this talent because I want to explode it at their feet and have it splash across the entire lane. That's a pretty cool idea. So I don't really need this. Only if a hero is hit do I get the mana back. So I don't really need that. I can totally do this all by its own and fire at their feet, explode it all over the lane. So actually I could go with that. Explosion length would be nice combined with this talent then. If I'm planning to shoot it shallow for the maximum damage in the back there. Then I could mark for the kill, incendiary elixir them, then jump them. And I don't have any choices there, and there's nothing really that would help me out. Maybe movement speed, man? No. Concentrated blast, increase Gilneas damage by 80% while Inner Beast is active. Well, Inner Beast is always active. So increasing his damage by 80% would be a pretty big deal. So I'm a cleanup melee assassin, but if I get in a group where there are other cleanup melee assassins, I do have a choice to become a little more area effect by going Gilneas Cocktail. So basically, okay, cool. So we kind of have three builds, right? So we have a build we can think about, which is all human. We're never going to really connect with them. It's too dangerous for us to ever jump in. They have too many CCs or we are missing support. So we're going to play extremely safe with a human enhanced build, getting increased range, disengage, all those sort of things. We have a Worgen build we can do where we go through and we make sure that our Worgen is top notch. We are diving in. We have Divine Palm, Divine Shield to keep us alive. Enough support, maybe double support if we don't have one of those sweet divine abilities. And we're going to do all the cleanup. We're going to blah, blah, blah as a wolf and kill everybody. Cool. And then we have this Gilneas Brew ability where we could do a bit of area effect damage if all of our team is single targets. Like we have an entire team of what, like Vala, Rainer, Kerrigan, Thrall, and myself. And we need a little bit of area effect damage, perhaps. But is the human build? Nope, because I'm missing out on the increased range here. And that's my prime talent. These two together, I think, make the real, plus that one, make the real stack here that I need. And at this level, I don't really have anything. The 20% movement speed with Inner Beast going could be pretty darn good. And I seem to be keeping it up over 3 seconds. Yep, I'm going to. So I'm about to take my break. I am going to queue up while that's going on here. I'm sure it'll take a while, and I will be back in about 5 minutes, and we'll get into some quick match here. That song's, it's neat and all, but I don't think it has anything on Werewolves of London. Or, you know, Metallica. But Bad Moon Rising, I mean, yeah, that Hungry Like the Wolf. I think we already went through the best werewolf songs there are. I promised my wife I wouldn't play the Twilight soundtrack. So I'm sorry, everybody. I know you're big Twilight fans out there. He hopes to have some talents and some supports there, Lirin. Let's see what we got on our team here. We got ourselves, oh, Brightwing. And a Taronda. Cool, so I'm double support. And what are we up against? We're up against Falstad, Muradin, Taronda, Kael'thas, and a Greymane. What did that Greymane take? No call yet. I think Hammer's probably best for the bottom. But we can always do our tower business and then end up... Oh, I still didn't change out my horse. So he went with the Gilneas Cocktail. Interesting. I think we're still going to go with that Wolfheart. And we will be ready this time. 45 seconds. First Chet pops. We will be there for it. We will not be farting off up top. Though Artanis is a decent idea to take the bottom if he went Seasoned Marksman. Nope, reactive parry. All right. Ho!
To victory.
Yep, just like a ship, Artanis. I was thinking the same thing. So let's make sure we don't get hit by a Taronda stun today. Into a... Yeah, there's a lot of stuns in this lane. Oh, nope. Oh, I walked right into it. But we're okay. Alright, we need a little bit of support for this. Kind of changes things when you get stunned and you lose your stacks of inner beast. Oh, Kael'thas is by himself all of a sudden. Woo! Alright. Oh, I guess we lost our inner beast, so we don't need to be stutter stepping like champions at the moment. Still got a Kael'thas. There's our enemy Worgen. I guess I would probably be best served just going in the top here. Interesting to note too, 30 mana for the Razor Swipes and 90 mana, or 80 mana it is, for that Gilneas Cocktail. So actually if I need to clear a lane, I can do it with much greater efficiency. If I turn into a Worgen. But we can go ahead and fire up the Stutter Steps. She's considerably lower than me if I can make a nice straight line and hit him with it.
The future belongs to those who take it.
So let's see, what do we want to do at this level? I don't think thick-skinned is really where we want to be. I don't know, that Gilneas Cocktail kind of build was cute. Here comes.
What do you want?
Let's stick with our original build and try the stealth out.
The beast hungers. I have your scent.
Now we are being a little lonely up here. But we're soaking XP for our team. Pushed up against the wall there. Kael'thas all by himself. Okay, getting a little hairy. Literally getting hairy. Cool, I got a Brightwing friend.
I will not accept defeat. That was much appreciated.
How many hits did I get? 8, which means my cooldown is now 7. Okay. I'm feeling that talent.
Honor and glory.
Looks like he also went the stealth talent.
My curse,
and he's a king. Alright, I got 11 hits. Should be a 4-second cooldown. 5 seconds, okay. Interesting. Seems like the first two hits don't count. Oh no! Disengage in 6. Actually, stealth not doing anything for me there. Interesting. Alright, human attack range, don't really need it. Impact, well, we missed out on our last talent. Kinda looking at those cocktail talents now, actually, really strongly. But we'll do the Wizen Duelist, we'll see what we can make happen. Hang out in Brightwing range, get some heals. It's like Hammer's making the call. We're gonna be invested here for a little bit. Sadly, this won't be enough, but hey, at least 2 coins will be off me. Let's hang out with Brightwing a little bit longer. Oh, Hammer! Did make a grave mistake, but I don't know if we'll actually be able to close with him. There we go. And I've got no mana! I've got double support, so I'm out of mana! Alright, well, even with no mana, as long as I stay in wolf form, I can keep a lot of DPS out on the map.
I will not accept defeat.
We'll just go straight from here. 2 seconds. 1 second. Ah. Alright, I'm not taking any camps by myself. Aw, oh, you dapper man, you. Brush it off. You're missing a sleeve, but brush it off. Ladies as pimps, too. Right, exactly. A waste of talent if they did have all reveals, didn't they? But we seem to be okay. Looks like some business is going in at the turn in. 6 off the Falstad. Yeah, we're not getting in there, even with Tyrande support. So that's going to be a cannon for them, and incoming on these two guys, we can assume. Luckily, Muradin's missing a lot of his stuns. Might as well keep it going. I'm invested until disengage is up. That's the rules we made for ourselves. Oh, wow. Ouch. Haymaker Muradin. Oh, he used... yeah. You could. Seems like an obvious statement, but he used the razor swipes to move to the other side of Artanis. So that he wasn't body blocked by the switch. It's a good idea.
To victory.
And he is out damaging me since he has the safety of the Gilneas cocktail build.
Your life is forfeit. Let me have this.
Interesting.
You think you can open both chests, you landlubbers? Who can grab me booty first?
I shall bury.
Looks like your foe beat you to it. Let this be a lesson to you. Let me handle this.
This is what I've been waiting for. Nice. Dueling lane with a single target. Oh, but that's not a single target at all, is it?
For honor and glory. I think they've had
but we're 10 now. So let's get that marked for the kill when we want to practice. I think anyone can select a dead character, a character that's already dead, for a go to the throat.
I fight for my countrymen.
Odd siege up position, but...
This is a hunt.
Hang on, right wing range. Looks like Hammer needs to be the turn in. Here comes Falstad, though. Pop that. I think we'll be invested here for a bit. Oh. Ooh. Where's our Bright Wing? Let's get up here. Get in range of them heals. Artan is fighting outside of Hammer range. What? Brightwing disrespecting. Apparently she's pretty proud of what she just pulled off. Guess I will clear out this mid and then go get me some manas. Alright. Top myself off here. They do seem to get away, don't they? And it doesn't seem like this attacks really delivers much when things can't stand still long enough. Maybe that's what the... I can't combine the talents, though. So let's stay on that unfettered assault. I don't know if in the long run that's what I'll be wanting, but... It's a great idea. Only problem is there is a sight tower in the way. I feel like I should just turn into a wolf really early on in the fight so I can make sure that I have disengage for when I want it. Alright, there's a top I'd like to clear out, but fight's breaking out here. Lots of different angles. Looks like it's going to come down to whoever can land the stun first, and they seem to have a couple more. Oh, Hammer, trying to make her way out of there. Nice save by the Brightwing, for sure. I have no real idea where I am in this fight. Oh no, I walked- Ah! Really lost track of myself there. What we died. Really poor choices. Fair enough. That's an accurate assumption.
Two chests at once. 10 heroes on a dead man's chest.
So we're falling behind. Not too bad. Got decent siege damage, but I've been off in lane doing stuff. Looks like we got a boss coming in. Well, we should be able to keep up with it. Actually, this toolkit works super well for bosses, doesn't it? And I really love that disengage, but I'm a big Tychus fan. And I've missed that slide. It's such a simple ability, but it gets so much done. And he's got two of them. One, two, three. Okay. Yeah, so it looks like it's good to take on mercenary camps. 12, and I get 9 seconds off. Weird. It's almost like the first two hits don't matter. You need to mobilize on bottom. I think we need to take the safe route. They might be going for those mercenaries.
Who's got the coin for me services?
The future belongs to those who pick it.
You've made a grave mistake.
All right. Seems like they're around here. Two levels up at the moment. There's a Kael'thas. Oh, if only it had hit.
Looks like
it's a bit of Tyrande. I dodged a mark for the kill there, but I could really use an enemy to lead to. Damn. Well, they certainly have more than enough stuns, don't they? We're not really getting in the melee on heroes very much. We can say that the tooltip might be, you know, it doesn't work for the first three hits or something weird like that. It's still, you know, performing its duties and decreasing the overall cooldown of my inner beast. I'm just curious to know how it works. Maybe the initial first 3 seconds need to pass? That's a few too many stuns, isn't it? Oh, he got me! Oh well, I guess I got two of them for what it's worth. Just a tap. Oh, the owl misses. There you go. And there's some coins in the base too. That's a pretty decent looking push. With four dead, could get some business done. It's like Hammer's on his way to raid the push. He's got 12 seconds, though. And now he has no sight. Oh, that's a nice idea. Well, it worked out for him. Looks like I need to help clear this out.
Seems we reached an accord. Let's show your enemies a jolly good time.
Time to fight for my countrymen. Victory will be ours.
Don't wait for me. Fire, you idiot.
Time to stretch my legs. Nowhere to hide.
No, time's up.
One less.
Oh, but it's on full cooldown. We're good. What does this cost me? 10 mana. Okay. No one grabbed the coins.
I fight for my countrymen.
All right, we're holding on. Getting two in on me isn't really going to do too much, but I understand their fears of letting them control the turn in. Oh, six on Tyrande. Okay, that makes a bit of a difference. Oh, you crafty butthole. We can assume... Yep, there's Muradin. Oh, our supports are out in front. Okay, and they're all invisible. And level 20.
Who can grab me?
Oh! And they took our top. Mercs. Okay, looks like... Well, we got three here. Trying to stay inside of Hammer's range, but she really needs to disengage proper. That's a dead Tyrande. belongs to those who. Lucky for us, they need 18 coins to get that turn in. Ah, oh, but Hammer got herself killed. No more holding back. Oh my! Someone stop that. Alright, let's try it out in a real world situation. They're probably boss. Nope, doesn't seem to be then. If we go defend the bottom. Alright, there's two. Still could be taking the boss, but without those two DPS, it would take a while. Looks like they could be thinking about it now, though. Muradin's actually pretty darn overextended. As long as we can keep kind of relocating ourselves. Alright. It's too bad we're dead out in the back of that. Ah, well. Okay. Interesting. Interesting game. Feel like our spec fell a little apart. I don't know. Let's take another look at it. Let's see what the enemy Greymane did, too. No, I always figured Greymane was going to be an assassin. Oh, daily quest. Nice. Let's take a look at the talents. So, enemy Greymane went with the cocktail, eyes in the dark as well, but did the bonus damage marked for the kill. Get out of here, chat. Get out of... Get... What? Yep, close. There we go. Running Wild, in fact. Relentless Predator. And Tooth and Claw. I can't think of a situation where I would really need that much cleave. But how did he do on damage? Oh, okay. So we were nearly neck and neck. He outdamaged me a little bit. Interesting. That stealth did nothing. That's a trick talent. Because the disengage movement speed is really all I need. And if that didn't work out for me, I'm dead. It doesn't feel like I'm going to dive in, fight for 6 seconds, and then somehow stealth my way out of there over 4 seconds. I've already disengaged about as much as I'm going to get. So let's avoid that talent now. I think we could put that talent to rest. Wise and Duelist never really came into play, which makes me think that this 200% increased damage could be what we want, which means on this level we can take the Galnaeus Cocktail. I did like this one. I liked relocating. I liked the movement ability it gave me, because no one's standing still for me to get off multiple auto attacks. What else do we have at level 13 we could do? And Relentless Pre- yep. Yeah. Cool, let's explore some specs while we get this back up and get into another quick match here. So, if we're not doing the stealth, because the stealth didn't really do anything. And yeah, I mean, Muradin, Tyrande, Kael'thas, it was extremely... It is a win more talent. You're absolutely right, Zelotok. And against that many stuns, I don't think we were going to win more. We had to defend more. So how can we adjust this? I really like Wolfheart. I don't think I need this. And I don't need reveals enemy heroes for 10 seconds if I hit them. So I would have to hit them first. That would reveal them for 2 seconds at least. But 10 seconds would be pretty nice. So I think we'll do the Wolfheart into the Drought. Yeah. Let's do the Drought. We'll do the Incendiary Elixir. That's a good pick. That'll be good all game. Then we'll march for the kill. I think we'll stick with the Unfettered Assaults. I really like the bonus movement on it. The increased 1 second cooldown is a bummer. But, I mean, even if I did do this, I need to... I hit them with the swipe. I have a animation cooldown of about half a second. Then my attack speed of 1 second goes off. I reduce it by 1 second, 2 seconds, but I've already overshot the reset by 0.5. So it is sooner, but they're not standing still in the first place, and I have no slow to get up on them. I think I want the movement. What about it, Math Magician? Great name, by the way. Characters to kill Worgens. Diablo does seem like it'll work pretty well. I mean, any sort of CC is going to lock them down pretty hard. Yeah, I mean, if you can keep them at range, you're reducing their overall damage by a lot. So I'd say any sort of melee CC heavy guy that is just ready for them if they come in, that's going to be pretty stellar. Alpha Killer. I haven't fought any double warriors or a Cho'Gall yet. Out on the BlizzCon show floor, where there was a Cho'Gall in every single, you know, game, Alpha Killer did amazing work. My damage was ridiculous. There was also no MMR on the BlizzCon floor, so I definitely abused some Cho'Galls, some newer players, and got a lot of extra damage in there. I disagree with Raynor players who say you should just go Giant Killer every game because you're auto-attacking anyway and giving you the increased damage is just what you're doing in the first place. I think auto-selecting auto-attack talents on Raynor, if you are learning Raynor, is a great choice. But you can never, ever underestimate the power of getting that bullseye, the double barrel into the bullseye. It wins games. If you're having trouble getting a good engage and you can get a stun off, you could win a game right off the back of that. I've certainly done it multiple times. So, but I don't think Giant Killer's ever an auto pick unless there's double tank on the enemy team. And double tank in my mind is including like Asmodan, because he's got such a ridiculously huge health pool and a normal tank. But bullseye can be where it's at. I feel like this isn't invested. I think this talent is the only one keeping me back. I got Inner Beasts available a lot of the time. 80% would not be double damage by any means. It would only be, you know, less than half damage added on. But with all this stacked together, could be pretty stellar. I can see why Running Wild would be popular, but it feels like I'll just overextend. And if I need to disengage, 35% of that cartwheel isn't going to be enough to save me. So yeah, I think we'll stay with the Unfettered Assaults for the movement. And then we'll try out Concentrated Blast. I think Relentless Predator is going to be really cool, but I think everyone in the game right now is looking to destroy Worgens. And if we can be the best human we can right now, I think we'll find ourselves with some success in the game. And then we'll go that Gilneas Roulette to see what happens. I don't even know if this will be worth it. I think my Hunter's Blunderbust, 4% damage behind the target. Depends how big that line effect is, but splash for 4%? Is that true? Is that real? That sounds... No, thank goodness. Okay, in-game it says splash for 100% of damage behind the target. Oh, that is a bad tooltip. That is misleading. Okay, both these say 4%. That's a scary idea. Yeah, it's 100%. No, we're good. So if we got ourselves this build, what else can we make? Let's see what other kind of builds we could make up here. I think we'll be going with this nice kind of middle-of-the-road build for this next game. We'll see what happens. But we could also make... Would we change anything to do a full-on, well-supported pocket healer gray main build while we wait for this to queue up here? I still think we would end up going with this talent. I think it's just too fantastic. Darkflight's all right. But we do need to live for our leap in, giving us that 2 those two attacks that would be slightly negated for our healers to catch up. So maybe we do the thick skin in that case into Wizened Duelist because we are that melee cleanup. Go for the throat. Running. No, we'll do visceral attacks for this one because we can dive in, go for the throat. The bullet goes, then we use that to jump in from increased range. This we can jump in, reduce the damage, then go for the throat for an additional jump in, which should means we're landing base attacks, which means that our razor swipes are good. Which would leave us with, I think, Relentless Predator in just about every game. And we could do Tooth and Claw, but Unleashed does have its potential. Right now in Artanis, people are actually going that ability at level 20 just because of the overwhelming odds of it winning a game for you. And they're not huge, but if you do end up going that Purifier Beam into targeted Purifier and someone does die, you could have a full team wipe, which is going to be a victory condition after level 20. And that's why people end up taking this talent so often right now, despite Force of Will being rather cool. And Nexus Blades, if you end up going that Seasoned Marksman and all, is going to deliver a lot for you, plus the movement speed decrease. Really interesting that here on Greymane we do not get Nexus Blades. I can see why, though, because then Visceral Attacks becomes an auto pick if we're slowing them by any amount, because I'm landing my auto attacks. And things change a little bit. Looks like we are good to jump into this. Dragonshire, nice. Greymane on the enemy team. It looks like we got a Nova, Artanis, Sonya, and Hammer, so no support. Falstad, Arthas, Greymane, Tyrael, and Artanis. Triple tank versus double tank. So let's play safe. Let's go ahead and do that Gilneas cocktail build we just worked out. I'm enjoying Mr. Main. I don't think we'll put out curtains anytime soon, but Greymane, I like him. He's got lots of flavor. I'm digging it. I would happily put him in the place of Thrall or Kerrigan with enough practice. Right, could. If I fail in that engage, I've got myself a lightning rod, a slow with the hammer ring, a lot of auto attack damage coming in on me. So no reason to just dive Falstad for fun. Nice, you're embracing him, Badger Lord. Found yourself a nice melee assassin. Oh, there we go. We made it. Everybody survived. I'm sure pandas hate new visitors in their pens, as most animals do. Chen gonna spend a couple solid weeks hissing at Greymane.
All right, ladies, keep firing till there ain't nothing left.
This pack will hunt well.
I'm looking forward to not getting. Huh. Why? Because everyone's gonna try to jump the Greymane? Well, let's see. So we are doing Wolfheart. We have to keep our inner beast active as much as possible, and let's go ahead and get in the habit of using cocktail while inner beast is up. But someone bought the bundle and got a lion? I don't have a lion. Oh, I forgot to change my mount again. Alright, so we'll only use cocktail while inner beast is active. That'll be good practice for when it finally goes down. Nice little mines there. And what is in our lane? Looks like we got ourselves a Tyrael. That's a good little position for him to teleport over to. So we'll just play careful. Wow. That damage really looks good on Falstad, doesn't it? And it looks like we got off enough attacks to decrease that cooldown by a couple.
And let loose the Dragon Knight.
Nice.
This is a hunt.
I
All right, once Artanis is back in lane, we'll go visit that bot. Looks like with Dunks here, we'll have a good chance for a gank. Let's make ourselves the first target available. Sure, Falstad will appreciate that. Go ahead and grab our well here, too. 13 hits, so we should have a 5-second cooldown. Yeah, so it is some sort of 3-second or 3-hit delay on that guy. Anyway, this looks well taken care of. Let's go ahead and hit up the mid. That stutter step is so different. 50% attack speed. I'm used to Raynor, who has 30% increased attack speed. So you can just really just stutter step the hell out of this guy while Inner Beast is on. Nice. Nova Greymane best friends. Though I am very low health. Alright, so we're gonna do that drought overflow, explosion length. Okay. That sounds good. Let's see how that looks on. Oh, where's our little thing gone? Oh, there it is, okay. It only shows if we. Yeah, so that is pretty darn big. So we should have no problem hitting Falstad here with it. And here comes our wave, so we can judge that it's right around the corner, but sadly, oh, just out of lane. Oh, looks like top's getting a little nutty. We also have a gray main in the bottom, going for the gank. Oh, he's still going. I got confused by the Artanis. There we go. Could have been a little quicker and saved my friends. Some indecision.
My curse will be their undoing.
I guess I'll go get that. They're fighting over that bottom a lot. In fact, they're sitting on top of it. Nope, there's Arthas. Oh, shoot. Oh, darn. The Duder guy got it. We'll wait for him to give us a kick, and then we can switch to the other side. Oh, is he not going to kick me? Guess he's not into that sort of thing. Guess let's go and disengage. Incendiary. Let's get up that top lane, and we got. So what this do? Increased damage, even if it misses. Cool. So now we can start aiming at the ground.
You've made a grave mistake. Nowhere to hide.
And 8 seconds. Nope, not happening today. Nice. Ooh, out of mana though. Interesting. Any changes we could make? Well, we got one here. Yeah. But only if we hit a hero, right? Nope, that's the wrong one. If it hits an enemy hero, wait a minute. If it hits them at all? Because if it just hits them at all, then we're fully spec'd to hit heroes 24/7. And actually, that is an amazing ability. I do really like Wolfheart. But if I'm having mana issues, it's like perfect aim. Once I get to...
Who will control the Dragon Knight's
power? Alright, well let's do that mark for the kill. Oh well, no, we got him.
Nice.
Is at hand.
I mean, who wouldn't want a 40-second cooldown on any of their abilities?
Free him and destroy
a minute does feel a bit long. Oh, we got 2 seconds till we can disengage, so might as well just stick on it. Not fast enough, but I have a well for myself, so I'll go ahead and grab this. Looks like Nova can ride the dragon. And, oh, well, I'm getting this. Sorry, buddy. Here comes Arthas. Oh my goodness, I won it. Okay, here comes Artanis. We're out of here. Did no one grab that medal? Darn it.
Let this be my atonement.
Atone for what? What'd you do wrong, Greymane? Your people or something? You curse your people?
Let me handle this. Retribution is at hand.
Eight combo, so five off. No? No, that went to eight. What? Nice job.
I will not accept defeat.
So what do we want to do here? I think last time we went with the running wild, didn't we? At least in theory, but I think unfettered keeps us up on the target. Let's try running wild, though. We are staying at range. We've got a ranged ability. A little bit of bonus leap range wouldn't hurt. Oh, I'm forgetting about my inner beast. Just hold. Hold, duders. Nope. Bottom got pushed out. Oh. Looks like they're taking both. Let's see. I've got a well here. Let's go ahead and grab it. I can take advantage of that regeneration too. Oh, snap! That was cool. Nice! Oh, someone didn't take the Shatters on the ground talent. And building, building, building! Nope, too slow. Wants to get top. Fine by me. Probably shouldn't be the one taking the damage. Alright, now we get ourselves Inner Beast. 80% damage.
It's the weapon of kings. Huh. You call these fortifications? Most assuredly.
Inner Beast. Bonus damage. Wow. 700. Let's leap a wall, let's leap a wall. Keep those auto attacks rolling, yeah! We're Inner Beast Masters! No, 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 aw. And once something's actually in range to be hit by my ability, we can go ahead and try the delete. Oh, oh, oh my, oh my. I'm behind the gate. I messed up. That's a bit much. Well, I got the kill, for what it's worth. Good to see Tyrael's making a comeback. All these Novas. All right, well, it's a winning engage. Oh no, Pepper. Has this game been out for 3 years? Has it already been out that long? I don't think so. 2 years? Are we really coming up on 3?
I will not fail my people again.
Kinda gets a little jostled, doesn't he? I did not have Inner Beast active during that Gilneas cocktail. There we go. Wait a minute. It did the same damage on everybody. To the first enemy hits and explodes. So do I get the explosion damage? That changes a lot, actually, if that's true. Because then I actually do need to hit my initial target. And aiming at the ground. Well, aiming at the ground makes it easier. Yeah. Yeah, so I do get the initial hit damage, and I get the explosion damage on the target. So I do want to hit a target. Not doing myself any favors. Oh, there I go trying to disengage. But Hammer's still here. As long as we are within her range, we're good. There's old Artie Pants. Ah. Oh, wait, I hit somebody. Yeah, I didn't want to leap to Falstad.
This is a hump.
Free the Dragon Knight and slaughter the enemy.
Destroy the enemy's core.
Yep, I agree. We can absolutely finish this. We got the time. I don't think we're gonna see how Hunter's Blunderbuss works here, but... Well, GG. Well, damn.
Victory.
You're right, Cheesy Bob. That was 2014, wasn't it? Okay, cool, so it's only been 2 years. Oh man, that worked well, didn't it? No, Bolt of the Storm is not an option for Greymane, nor is Nexus Blades. I get a choice of two decently interesting talents, but none of the usuals, which is interesting. Let's see what the enemy Greymane ended up doing. Perfect aim. Alright, I gotta test something. I gotta test something. Let's do the shop and we do the try so we can get ourselves the recount off of that target dummy. I think so, Karsus.
Most assuredly.
Alright, we're level 20, so that's good.
Prepare to be enlightened.
So let's do this. So 150 damage. Cool. Let's go ahead and set it to perfect aim, explosion length, impact, and always explodes.
Victory.
So, all right, 245 or 253. I mean, 453. There we go. We got it. Okay, 453, but we hit with it. Nine, what? Because the, okay. Wait, no. What happened there? Oh, I must have doubled up. No, because, yeah, 900 is that number combined with the previous number.
I will not accept defeat.
All right, so let's let that fade off. And let's try it with a full connect. It's the same. What am I missing?
Let me handle this.
Length. Enemies impact and explodes even if it misses. Enemies impacted. Oh, okay. But hang on a sec. Maybe we're just a little too close then. Just splash damage.
For honor
And now a hit. Seems to be doing the same damage. Is something about heroes? Maybe it doesn't work on this guy? I don't know. I did like the unfettered. I think that worked well. I like the movement it gives. 80% while energy is active. 850. Okay.
The future belongs to those who take it.
817. 450. 817.
My curse will be their undoing.
Okay. Maybe I'm just not out of range enough. Why is it doing the same damage?
It is time to strike.
Well, this didn't really tell me what I wanted it to. I guess we'll have to discover with time. Oh, try the same thing without the talents? Good call. Let's give it again. Let's give it another go. I'm just trying to see if the initial hit and then explosion hits the same person. Because if so, I need to stop aiming at the ground. So we're level 20 here. So we got... did nothing. Oh, toggle cooldowns. Did nothing. 151. 151. I don't care what happens at this level. Let's do... why not? Does that change the graphic at all? I don't know, that'd be kind of cute. Explosion length. Cool. Impact. There's that 425. Which means I'm getting the 200% bonus damage when I hit an enemy. It impacts and explodes even if it misses. Okay, so they do all appear to be taking the exact same damage. Is that because 200, so 150, no, that's 450. To the first enemy it hits. Weird. Let's reset these talents. Because there we see the difference. Because there we can see the tiny white number pop up. And the other ones are much more affected. Once we go and get our talents, though, they're all hit by the exact same damage. And they all are missing... well, that front one does look like it took a little less damage. Oh, the back one, okay. The back one's a wizard. He has less health in the first place. So these two guys, we know, have the same health. And they are equally affected. So there may be an issue with this talent. And he only died first because he was getting auto-attacked once or twice there. Either way, if this is... I mean, this means that the 200% more damage to the enemy it impacts and explodes even if it misses. It impacts. It seems like it's doing 200 increased damage to everything. Which would be a broken skill. 250. Reset talent. Well, that did nothing, of course. There's 450 in the background, though.
Victory.
Yeah, and 151 in the front. But when we get... and this doesn't affect anything. It just makes the size bigger. And always explodes. So he's affected by both. Okay, so it doesn't actually increase the damage to 302... it puts it up to the explosion damage of 454, which is straight up incredible and ridiculous. Recredible. Or ridiculous. Yeah. Okay, so that's an overpowered talent. There seems to be some sort of error there. Good to know. Wait, hang on. What's the chat saying?
This curse will be my greatest weapon.
Oh, so the word... Right, because... Oh, you're right. Yes, so, yeah, you're absolutely right. Because that would be 300 damage, the 200%, plus the previous 150, making it 400, making it the exact same damage as the total explosion. Which means, though, that it is an incredible talent, and I don't have to aim it, and I don't have to hit heroes. Which makes it even better. Cool. Well, that's good to know. I'm glad we figured that out. Let's give it another go. Oh, looks like we're on a different screen here. There we go. Let's get back over to Greymane. So we got ourselves a nice wolf build. We've made ourselves... Oh, that's Artanis there. Let's get back to Greymane here. Oh, my mount! Yes, good call! Good call. Let's see. Well, we got a motorcycle for him. A Malthiel mount would be pretty good, though. Oh, yes. No, we're going wolf. Wolfception. Cool. So, right now, I think... I'm having a heart. What do you guys think? What do you guys think about Wolfheart? Just from... Because I've been playing this, so I've got my own perspective from executing the moves. But what do you guys think of between Wolfheart, where I'm basically getting my cooldown reduced by 10 seconds every time, or the perfect aim to keep my mana high? I guess in that last game I had double support, so let's make that the call, perhaps. I think Wolfheart is better, but if we have double support, let's do perfect aim. Yeah. I'm worried about the increased range because I don't want it over distancing the cone that I want to create in most situations. Granted, if they're closer, I'll just hit them in the face with it and then it'll explode where I want to. So maybe that's not an issue. Yeah, in the late game, most heroes, even Kerrigan, don't have any late game mana problems. So that's a good call. Maybe it is a bit of a crutch and this will serve us entirely throughout the late game. I agree. So we got... Yeah, so let's stick with that. Plus, we're going to need it for our 80% concentrated blast later on. I'm loving Unfettered Assault. Oh, what are you doing, Badger Lord? You said you got to play quite a bit of Greymane this morning. What are you taking at level 16? 13. Sticking with that mark. Boom, boom, boom. And I think we're going to stick with the Gilneas Roulette for now. Unless something informs us otherwise. Being able to just shoot through an entire group of heroes... for the damage and the vulnerability is just too powerful. Level 13? Visceral attacks? I don't know. I feel like I'm not staying up on heroes very much. Whereas Unfettered Assault is giving me an extra movement speed ability and allowing me to body block them, end up on the other side of them after I do the slash. But if visceral attacks has been working out, then it is the preferred talent. People are just running away. You're taking On the Prowl. Okay, with how much we are using Inner Beast, the movement speed could be useful, particularly to continue getting Inner Beast on the cooldown. Maybe in that case, Viciousness plus On the Prowl would be the better choice, because we have an extra second and 30% movement speed to get us to that next wave of minions, or to re-engage with that next power. But if we go Wolfheart here, I think we're pretty good to do any of these. Not getting range at level 1 feels wrong. I hear ya. But, as I mentioned, my concern is, of course, I don't want to have too big of a range and overshoot my targets. I guess that's not... That's a weird fear. I'm just thinking I break it on the ground and I know exactly where that cone's going. If I shoot at a hero, there's a chance someone will walk in front of it and detonate it early. So breaking it on the ground in short range will equal more controllable results. Disengage range. I think it's a good talent. I think it's a good safety. 35% of the disengage isn't a lot, but I did like the 35% on my dive there. That seemed very useful in that last game. Cool, we got this build. Let's try, I'm gonna go Wolfheart. It's because of concentrated blast. I need Inner Beast to be active for my 80% increased damage. I know. I think I need it with this build. And with this guy, I think we can be pretty open to what we want to do. And that little bit of movement speed probably doesn't actually benefit from... So let's do Running Wild in this case. Cool, we got a great, like, pseudo-human build going on. On the right side, we got basically the wolf build that I think we'd do if we were the solo assassin, the melee cleanup with a bunch of bursts and some double support. Let's see if we can get a non-brew human build. I think that would be our next step. All right. So a non-brew human build. What does that look like? And we're on Rainer here, but we'll fix that. Let's see. We want Greymane. Oh, right. Human. I don't think anything really changes here. I think we'd still want uptime. Increased range. Oh, wait, no. That's just the stealth. Interesting, and I have to become a wolf in order to do the stealth in the first place. So is my human build just the Gilneas cocktail build? The stealth's kind of cute. 10% range missing out on that, or 20% range missing out on that talent there. Maybe it's the mana so I can... Bam cocktails? Unbuffed cocktails? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Well, shoot, I think if we try to do some sort of human build, we just end up back at a Gilneas cocktail build. The only thing that changes is maybe this 100% fire through splash damage on the blunderbust. That's not a very big change. Yeah, no real generic talents at all throughout this thing. I mean, he has his own versions of them. I mean, we have a gathering power here that works basically the same, but increases your basic attack damage, which is very interesting, which means we want that visceral attacks because we're going to be doing basic attacks the whole time. And it'd be good for being human too. Actually, yeah. Well, no, we got the range there. I think we do need that. Running Wild probably at this level for that disengage since we invested the Eyes in the Dark talent. Yeah, so we'll do Eyes in the Dark, the disengage, probably in this case. I guess if we were ranged, there would be some CC in front of us, and we're trying to be the ranged assassin here. So Executioner isn't a bad idea, and then we take that talent there. Oh, what did we get? What is our... Ooh, nice. We got a Morales. That should be fun. Well, we kind of invented three builds, but I think in the end, Gilneas Cocktail seems to be it. I would not have expected that at the start of today, but I believe it. I think it's where it's at right now. I do find Eyes in the Dark underwhelming, which is why I think this talent build for the human only isn't really coming together. I think we've really kind of discovered our human builds here, and we have a Worgen assassin build that is kind of just painted out for us pretty clearly. But I think we've done a stellar job today finding, and of course, I'm saying this right now, like, yeah, man, like, woo, go me, like, I made a build, all right, let's post it up, you know, and then, you know, come tomorrow, I'm entirely wrong, we all figured out something I was missing, my Lunara build from last time was okay. I think the reveal I undervalued a lot, and in fact, that is the number one level talent I want. Anyway, let's take a look here. We got Greymane, myself, Morales, Zagara, Sonya, Diablo. I like the double tank. I like the Morales. Double burst. And they have the Malfurion for it, too. So those guys aren't going to be running out of mana anytime soon. That's going to be a little dangerous. So let's not get blown up by spellcasters today, which I think means... Oh, yeah, that looks pretty stellar. It's a good-looking lane. Well, Zagara can handle her own. Let's go help out Sonya. And, you know, let's give it a shot. Let's see. Oh, I can't. Never mind. I keep thinking, perfect aim. Sure, let's do it. But then I think about Wolfheart. Nope, it's Wolfheart. It's impactful on characters like Asmodan. I don't know if it'll really do too much against burst assassins who get killed more often. But Asmodan has a lot of survivability, will absolutely 100% run out of mana, and Malfurion is a great addition to him. Let's go visit that mid, shall we? Oh, looks like Sonya bit off a little bit. Oh my goodness. Can use that to relocate, but oh! Did not expect the surprise Artanis there. Bummer. Sure. Asmodan, Malfurion in a lane together. That is going to be a bit cheesy. Oh, I mean, who doesn't love a good Malfurion who acknowledges using their mana ability? I feel like in most games it just kind of goes underutilized. The good news is about against Kael'thas here, and we can see that he's actually solo in lane, is we can jump to the other side of him. So I'm curious to see if we can actually kind of pull off some more Illidan-like moves. It's one of the great powers of Illidan against Kael'thas is that it's really hard for him to land a decent gravity lapse. And I should have a 2-second cooldown on that one. Steal yourselves, heroes.
Let's go.
Looks like I can count still three in the middle. There's Jaina moving up for me. There's Artanis, so I'm not going to activate it. Got Morales coming in. Let's wait for Morales. Need those heals. Barry. Oh, tank for a tank. Got some Morales loving going on. Nope, a little too early for that. Not really having it out. Looks like we lost our Sonya too. Oh, Malfurion. Excellent, I'm getting a lot of attention from this Morales. Love that. But I'm out of mana! Looks like Morales is out of mana too, though. Cool, that went well. I'm gonna grab my well, because it went so well.
Join us in battle, mortals.
I will not accept defeat.
Let's go ahead and stay at range. What is that level for? Just the explosion length. And there's the disengage. Oh, snap! A kill with the cactail. Cactail. Ah. Oh, right. Well, clearly this is going to attract the attention of everybody. Let's go ahead and get ourselves out of here. I will not accept defeat. Fall back. Need that mana. Here we go. Incendiary elixir. Diablo in the top. Looks like Diablo's going in on the Malfurion. I like that. Though, Morales might need some aid. Though, I don't know where Malfurion's off to. I think we can help out a lot here. Looks like we got incoming.
Now this is a hunt.
A shrine's gathering for my countrymen.
11 seconds. They're going to come from the top here. I don't really have any way to set up any sight or anything. We need Zagara and Morales. So let's wait for them. We can get an early delete off on somebody. That'd be awesome. And we have our talents for the cocktail now. Actually, probably the preferred build you would want to do on Infernal Shrines. Make sure we don't get swapped by that Artanis. Looks like he's actually coming up around the top. Yep, there he is. Nice. Oh, right into the roots. Sonya's moving in, though. Nice. Oh well. A bit of a pursuit.
I can feel my strength returning. Let me handle this. Retribution is at hand.
Alright. Awesome. I'm gonna grab that mana. Definitely having mana issues. But I love Inner Beast. Up and do exactly what you want to do. Kael'thas all by himself?
My curse will be their undoing.
I suggest I agree. This mercenary camp. Zagara's got all that. Well, they want to push the wall. And we have some great support to do it with. Probably best that that wasn't in range. Could have just gotten myself in a lot of trouble, but we can go ahead and Inner Beast. Inner Beast, yeah. Inner Fire, Inner Beast. Damn it, Blizzard. Stepped in the blizzard. Make sure we don't get swapped. Oh shoot, I'm stimmed! I don't have any mana. Ah, what a time to be out of mana, huh? Close one, too, so No point in me going back for mana. I'll position myself towards the back. Go ahead and inner beast. Yeah, this cocktail build is fantastic. I don't even have enough for the bullet. I think we got someone. It sounded like we got someone. No, Jaina. Well, in this particular build, we don't need that range, so what do we do? It's, yeah, running wild, I think, is our best bet. I've been for days. I can go stop that top, too. That Punisher, they're all going to be up for it with two bursts behind a wall. We're not going to get too much done there. Yep. Zagar is right to make that call. Those two guys need to be careful. So there's 16. So we should have an instant cooldown and... Okay. Weird. Weird how that ability is working out. Oh, looks like they're breaking it out. Oh no! Oh no, disengage, disengage, disengage! Oh wait, I was in the wrong form. Never mind. My bad, that was just panic. You can do it, Sonya. Nice job. Boy, Stim lasts a while, doesn't it? That's a good point. I'm using potions less than perhaps my build would inform me of, but actually a lot of my tools are very powerful still. Being able to dive in, get some amazing auto attacks off. I'm spending a lot of time in human form, so maybe I do need to cast some more Gilneas cocktails. And it comes down to mana at that point. At any hoop, Concentrated Blast is the whole reason we're missing out on mana efficiency at our level 1 talent, so let's take advantage of it. Let's see what kind of damage we can do out on the field here. Where is the enemy? Oh no, we're killing him too fast! For my inner beast. That did a lot of damage to all those. Got quite a bit in. Laser on me. And that is cheap, actually. Dark Flight, I need to use that a little more often. That is not causing my mana issues. It's cocktail at 80 mana. So hitting one target there had very little value. Now let's go ahead and stay at range. There's a lot of spell abilities flying out here. Oh, well, I did get someone. I'm not leaping to that target, though. Well, I felt like I was going to go down anyway, so might as well try to get as much damage in as possible. And looks like I actually lowered them enough for Sonya to do some cleaning up, which is nice. Oh my goodness, barely getting out of there. Great job by the medic, but no! Medic! Diablo! Well, yeah, you do what you can. And he'll be back instantly. Looks like Zagara got the top four too, so we're going to be A-okay. So currently, this is my build here. I think we'll try one more game after this with that level 1 Talon, see how it feels. But either way, I need to focus up and make sure that Inner Beast is active when I cast my Gildnayan Cocktail.
To victory.
Another shrine will be active soon. Do not let our enemy.
Much better cooldown.
Absolutely.
What do we got? We got some dudes chilling. God, the damage is fantastic. A long cooldown on my beast. Oh, miss! Nice. Oh, I killed him too fast! Ruined my beast! Alright, let's do that roulette. That should be pretty fantastic with the Zagara ult going. It is hard being Worgen. You have no first aid or anything if you don't have any sort of support. Doing a Worgen build out of that does not work out. But I'm kind of eating my theory crafting hat here. I thought Gilneas Cocktail was going to be my most ignored talent. When in fact, it really kind of, putting all the points into it, fills out the kit. Kind of like Diablo putting all his points into Flame Wave. It just sort of makes it mana efficient and useful. And without those talents, I feel a little naked when it comes to just doing area effect damage or something else more interesting. Nope, I missed. Well, GG. Well, all right. Victory. That's a good question, Kilo. I know we talked about that in the last ITN, was really thinking about what your combo is. And if you're new to me or ITN or anything like that, when I talk about combos, I'm talking about things you can deduce from your abilities that you can stack together. So one of the ones we didn't talk about on that show, which is pretty interesting, is Falstad. And identifying his combo is pretty easy. What you want to do is Lightning Rod and Barrel Roll. Oh, but well, you know, the screen's a little busy right now, but, you know, we can still make it out. Lightning Rod, Barrel Roll. You put in your Lightning Rod, you Barrel Roll after them if they try to move outside your circle. So, and then that is your initial beginner combo. Land your Lightning Rod, keep them in the circle. If they try to escape from it, you Barrel Roll after them. Then you can add the Hammer Ring on top of it for a 25% slow, making it that much easier to keep them inside your circle. So then the combo becomes Hammer Ring, Lightning Rod, Barrel Roll. Greymane doesn't really have one of those right now. It's very fluid, which makes him a lot of fun. With talents, of course, there's some combos. I always want to keep up the inner beast. Actually, before we have this conversation, let's go ahead and queue back up. But I haven't really identified anything directly other than leaping in and, of course, using your abilities that trigger once you've leaped in. So there's no true sort of make it easier on yourself combo. Let's clean up the screen a little bit. It's gotten messy. And we couldn't really decide on a third build for Greymane, but I think we can. We'll make the call here. We're going to go full cocktail, marked for the kill. I think Running Wild did us some favors there. And then the Gnaeus Roulette for talent build number 2. This is our Worgen one. I think we'll do the Wolfheart thick skin. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty unique. And then our third build here. And this is this window. So let's go ahead and grab ourselves a new one here. That's not working out. Come on, you can do it. There we go. Heroes. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Talent calculators. Greymane. All right. All right, so our Greymane build. So this will be the non-Gilneas cocktail. Yeah, so an auto attack range build, which I think would leave us at, yeah, Wolfheart. Probably stealth? Range on human. But why am I going into Worgen if I'm doing a human build? So I don't need that. Inner Beast causes my mana to regen, so what, I could machine gun cocktails? But I don't have any cocktail talents. So I think I still stick with that. Then probably the movement speed. That sounds good. Into probably Executioner, because I have melee assassins with CC and such to support them. And then Blunderbust. So I think we're stretching a little bit at this point. But this looks like this could be our three builds. I'm definitely 100% favoring this initial one on the left here. I think this could be good. This, I don't think, really has a place right now. But we'll see. So, yeah. Get one more game in here. And we'll see. See if we can't keep our mana high with that perfect aim, though we seem to be doing rather fantastic. And this build seems to be working quite well for us at the moment. Sure. Yeah, the Diablo patch did come out today, a little unexpected. And with Greymane at the same time, certainly a lot of Blizzard content for one day. Certainly been more than enough people excited about this guy. I want to see my skins. How can we dress ourselves up in the long run here? What are we going for? What are we unlocking? Oh! So they put out the patch, but the season doesn't start Friday? That's kind of odd. I mean, I like that it starts Friday. Well, sure, it's squishy, but I mean, would you trade reduced damage to have him not be? Then he's a warrior with some sort of weird ranged attack build you can do just in case. And I think that kind of defeats the purpose of, you know, doing a warrior or something. That's a shame. I was thinking too about jumping into some Diablo. It's been a bit. Ever since I got my Malthiel mount. Oh, the white one's rightfully kept for the back, but this one's pretty fantastic. I love the claw. Oh, and the one red eye, that's pretty... Oh, hey, oh. Huh. So if you get Master Skin, he loses an eye. Interesting. I do like it, though. Not sure why this one's saved for last. Oh, and he's got a little cape. I like the capes. That's a good Master Skin touch. If you're not just going to cover them in spikes, giving a character that previously had no cape a cape is a good call. This one's just silly. No way. Ugh. Oh my god. Oh, that's too wacky for me. Ideally, I think we maybe put him on one of these guys. But I haven't wanted to cough up the $10 for it. The Robo Horse would look good too. Kind of that steampunk blunderbust. Mmm. I kind of dig this. The white one with the white Morgan. Sadly, I can't see what the human looks like. In the various forms. Oh, nice. That's pretty stellar.
Rage will be unleashed.
Change his name to McIntyre. Okay, maybe I can see why that's saved for the final go. Though, is he missing an eye? Does he have an eye patch under there or something? Why is he missing an eye? And I'm physically moving. Of course, it's not going to give me a different angle. But I can't get under there. Right? I think we're just going with the Dire Wolf mount. From old World of Warcraft. And we'll get a gold one here, which will look pretty stellar. Bumblebee colors. Put him on a Mecha Spider. Yeah, the big top's just weird. I ain't into that. Though I do like the eye patch. The lion is... Oh, Captain America. Wow, Uncle Sam. Oh, jeez. Hall of Presidents.
My rage will be unleashed.
It's just so wacky. I like this one, though. It's got some good colors to it. And even the lion isn't too bad. Certainly don't need no lion mount. Oh, this thing is ridiculous. So lumpy. I think like everyone out there, I was hoping for some Space King Leoric today. But we did not get him. Cho'Gall sale, which is interesting. Which means you can buy Cho'Gall? Yeah, because the quests are over, so you have to buy him. Does that mean he's available for gold? Yeah. Looks like Cho'Gall is purchasable now. No support. Well, I think we got the right build for it. Ooh, no tank either. Outside of Hammer, who is a tank, but... Enemy team has an Abathur and a Zeratul. So Abathur might go healing build. It won't do too much. We got our own Nova, Lenara, and a Zeebo. Actually, Lenara is amazing against teams without any sort of healing because that damage over time just is damage over time. And as they run away, you get those sweet, sweet moments as they die from the poison damage. I'm not sure I'd call them pay-to-win skins, but yes, the skins are pretty wacky. I don't think we've had a skin on the caliber of Infested Tychus since the game came out. I can cover mid, but so can a wide variety of people. So we are going scented... Nope. Never mind. We could, but I think we'll be okay. I'm not terribly worried about Zeratul. And revealing Zeratul isn't like revealing Nova. We also don't have any dive to take advantage of the fact if we even get a view of the Zeratul. We're not going to get him as he gets away. So we're doing that perfect aim. Range by 30% refunds mana. Later on, we'll have to be really careful about Inner Beast and making sure that it is off cooldown. And we won't be waiting 16 seconds to cast a 9-second cooldown spell. But hopefully,
fast.
Hopefully we'll be able to work that out just fine. Oh, Sylvanas. I got myself an uppity one. Nice. Well, that was fun. Gotta be careful how much damage I take, though. I could attract Zeratul. And where is Zeratul at the moment? Let's go ahead and mount up. There's Zeratul. He's up top. If this hits, what's the tooltip say? If it hits an enemy. Hero. Oh, we have to hit heroes. Range hits an enemy hero. But if the splash hits a hero, are we good? We've got 400 mana starting very soon. I'm going to wait till 400 mana just to make this easy on my mind. And let's see if we hit Sylvanas. Do we get our mana back? We do. And we didn't hit her directly. Cool. Good to know. So as long as we hit a hero with the ability, regardless if it cracks on them, we're good to get our mana back. I really want to tank this, but I guess we really don't have any better options outside of Nazebo. Let's keep an eye out for that Zeratul who might stop by. Alright. Well, this is going to be pretty easy. We can just target all the Gilneas cocktail talents. Man, messing up your inner beast is pretty detrimental with this build. Looks like they zoned him out, and we got two in the middle, so let's make sure Sylvanas doesn't get to just go crazy on our wall here. Don't really have the health for this business, though, with two of them out there. That was a pretty obvious incoming stun. I think we'll stick around for one more cocktail. Ooh. Alright, yeah, let's go ahead and get out of here. We must bring the magic of the temples. How's damage? Right behind Anova. That would have been bad in the past, but these days, that's pretty good. Looks like, I hope Nazebo can go take the bottom, get himself set up for the future. Oh, I didn't have a hero there to hit, so that's gonna cost me. Yeah, since I'm by myself, I should have enough targets to... Oh, there's three in the bottom now. Who left? Nazebo is a computer. This Kerrigan really wants to get me. The old circle. The old Kerrigan counter circle. Oh, that should have hit. I want to disengage. Where's Zeratul? He's top. Cool, good for us. Alright. The curse grows stronger.
My curse will be their undoing. It seems a hero.
Let's see. Actually, Ryan, we're kind of settling on a build. I think we've made it pretty far today. Ah, mines. Looks like it's a mine build Abathur for sure. Alright, we got Sylvanas in the top. She can get a lot of damage done. Is this still a computer Nazebo? I don't really want him to be on me, but better than whatever else ideas an independent Nazebo might have.
assuredly.
Nice if I could clean that up, but I don't think. Actually, I do have Gilneas cocktail. That's not really enough. That's a shame. Sadly, our Nazebo computer is gonna mess us up quite a bit. Oh my goodness, she found me! Right, well, hey, that'd be nice if it had a reduced cooldown, but. I think that'd be a little bit overpowered. It's definitely an obvious choice after engaging to disengage. Dark flight into the disengage, so waiting the 6 seconds seems appropriate. And within the realms of my comfort for the punishment of it. Last second disengage there, no point in using. Alright, we were porting back. Do that mark for the kill still. Don't my talents look nice and blue? And let's stop Sylvanas. If I control the Nazebo, it's just not going to work out very well. Victory, the hours. Victory. Where's everyone else? I killed the Sylvanas once, so maybe it's just her. Maybe she doesn't. No. Maybe she doesn't play very safe, but I feel like if you're in this position. So she was by herself. Oh dear me. Oh, I did the wrong talent. Damn. Because I shot the bullet, I became a human, and then disengage didn't work because I was already human. And I dark flute instead all over the ground and accomplished nothing. But hey, Lunar's Nazebo getting us a tower. That'll be good for XP. This man up computer Nazebo. Come on. Aw, help her get out, buddy. Well, let's see if we can burn through this guy pretty fast. Make sure he doesn't reach our walls nor get too many kills. Oh dear me. What's going on up there? What's probably going on is go for the throat. Sounds like. Yeah, it is. It's exactly what's happening. And I probably have incoming on me.
My curse will be their undoing.
It's like he got out of here. Let's see if I can keep us from getting too surprised. Run in a circle.
You look a bit withered. Heal up.
I will not accept defeat.
Oh dear me. Alright, Sylvanas. Alright, well at least we got the Sylvanas.
Peace. What do you want?
Yeah, Inner Beast is not really up at all very much without that level 1 talent. Cute move, but she keeps working by herself. So let's do Running Wild. And I'm concerned about my level 16 pick, because Inner Beast is never really up without my talents to keep it up. So maybe we'll go with something else on this level.
curse will be their undoing. Victory will be ours.
All right, let's see if we can get old computer Zeebs out.
I will not accept defeat.
Particularly because he is. Darn. Oh, come on, tank. Oh, a little stutter stepping, man. Just a little bit of stutter stepping. No, you're dead. You're dead. Man. Oof. Yeah, stuns do counter him pretty well. In that case, well, in this case, our computer Nazebo's keeping us down a bit. We're losing tons of XP to that Abathur. He's doing a great job. In fact, I'm top XP. Probably from just that time I went to the bottom there. Nice shot. Just a little more. There we go.
Was a kill on the move.
So what should we do here? We got all the talents for it. I guess we'll give Concentrated Blast a go. We'll just really have to focus up and make sure. Hey, three of them dead. Well, nice job, that Nova.
What do you want?
Guess I should have had. Should have had Inner Beast open, but we can pop it open here. Come on down, come on down, come on down. Ah, you slow pokes. You guys suck. Alright, that's a big push in the bottom. Hammer, perhaps should go take care of that. Nazebo would be a good choice, wherever he is. Well, Nova's back up. That looks like they're getting cleaned up up top. Ah, gross.
My temple's power has been expended.
Oh well, let's see if we can move on that Kerrigan. And we're levels behind, which is good practice. Get a good feel for how it's actually going to be. Aw, oh, Nova died. Looks like to splash damage. There goes Zeratul. There he is. Not much I can do against him unless I'm in Worgen form. Now we gotta go heal. And no abilities, right? There's no owls or anything we need to worry about.
Absolutely.
Greymane is definitely an ambush assassin with a nice safety net in his ranged human form. But he's still countered by the same things that any sort of ambush or melee assassin would be. CC. He has no CC of his own or any sort of healing abilities. No matter how you spec him, there is no way for him to regenerate any health. Which does make his dive unique from Kerrigan's, which is nice. Just a long cooldown. Dead Abathur is good though. I got a Nova with me. If only she could get both of them. Oh, and the mark's still on him. You better get out of there. Nope. Oh, run in a circle. You gotta do the thing. Bummer. What are these two doing down here? Oh, Nazebo. Oh, come on, dude. Yeah, computer.
Your foes have annihilated
No, you might want to stop. You should just give up. Oh no, oh no, one more touch. Get out of there. Oh, they're coming around the corner. You're not fast enough. Here comes the ghosts. Ah, but they're going in with the slaps. Oh, here it comes. Had nothing to seal the deal with. Oh, and these Abathur locusts are gonna mess me up. Alright, well that's something. There's another dead Abathur. Ooh, okay, let's clean that up fast. There he is. There he is. Let's see if we can do it. Got kind of low health here, but let's see. He wants me. Oh, Nazebo made it. Should have leapt him, saved the leap on the mark for the kill to the last second, and stayed after him after the blink. But a bit of muscle memory that'll be taught in the long run. Ooh, we gotta get both.
Let me handle this.
Either way, good practice playing Greymane from behind. Not gonna learn much just decimating fools. Don't really want to move out on the map by myself. And I don't want to use much of all anything. Alright, we got an Abathur right in the area. Sadly, we need to get that bottom Kerrigan out by herself, though. Oh, but that leaves a... Aw, oh, come on. I want something. Aw. Oh. Well, can't run from him. Well, here comes the end. Oh, well, it was a good experimentation. Had no mana problems at all, but of course I had no support. So, I'm gonna die more often. I'll have to go back every time I'm at low health. And that's not gonna work out. So, no point taking mana reduction talents if you don't have any support to keep it going. So... yeah, I think that was some good experimentation. I will be back Thursday for ITN. That is at 5 p.m. Pacific time. I will have, right now, replay analysis is good to go for Friday. Of course, you know, jobs and all that sort of thing. Things could come up. But for now, we're good to go for Friday for some replay analysis. Got plenty of replays, but you can shoot those over to soloqnacast@gmail.com. That is all over the bottom information here on the Twitch page. So thanks everyone for watching. Thanks for joining me for the Greymane investigation. And I will see you all Thursday, if not sooner. Take care, everybody.